not a restaurant, we are a churrascaria, a Brazilian steakhouse, a culinary destination. Take your taste buds on a journey to Brazil where you will enjoy mouth-watering Brazilian meats. Our gaúchos personally prepare...
The official bird of Delaware isn't red. It's not green or purple. It's blue. Coincidence? We think not. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield Delaware. This blue hen does not need to see a podiatrist. But if he did, waiting for a referral might get his feathers in a bunch. And he wouldn't like that one bit. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield Delaware.
Hi guys, it's great to be here.
In the desert.
At the mall.
On the mountain.
At school.
At the beach.
In the Big Easy.
Yeah.
Today I want to show you guys the next gen Chevy Equinox. What do you think?
That's pretty.
Pretty sexy.
It's all wheel drive, look at that.
It looks aggressive.
But not overbearing.
It's not too big, not too small.
Looks like it could go off-roading.
But at the same time, it looks like a car you could take to a nice event.
You can dress it up or dress it down.
Seems like the perfect car for anybody.
I would take it anywhere.
I want one.
I love it.
She's a bad mamma jamma.
Chevy stepped their game up.
Whether you're a morning person or simply it's not your thing. Maybe you're the type that doesn't take it that seriously. Or you're that person who just makes everyone's morning brighter. There's a McDonald's for every morning.
Enjoy a sausage burrito for $1 or a sausage McGriddle sandwich for $2. Pair it with any size freshly brewed McCafe hot coffee for $1.
UD Blue Hen Football, powered by State Farm. There for you when things go wrong, but also here to help life go right. Talk to an agent today.
Once it into the post to Nick Harrison.
We've all been there.
Can't even see the score.
Oh my God.
Trying to watch the game on that tiny screen. It's time to watch sports the way they were meant to be watched. On this, in high definition. You can now watch all your favorite teams and players on the big screen for free. With CAA.TV, you'll never miss a moment. Take back the living room by searching CAA on your device.
The best part about playing in the CAA...
The best part about playing in the CAA is...
By far the competition.
All the competition.
Each week, you never know what's going to happen.
We've had multiple teams win national championships.
James Madison, Kings of the FCS.
We got a lot of great players in this league who can make a play anytime.
When you have to prepare for the CAA teams each and every week, and that's what prepares you for playoffs. I think that's what makes it the most dominant conference.
to our last two teams in the 12 teams in 12 day series.
Stoppage 3:09, and they're going to start in their own territory, backed up at the 8-yard line. J.P. Caruso is the quarterback. Kareem Williams is the running back, and Kareem will get the give to the right side. Not a whole lot of room to run, but staying on his feet, digging for some yards. They blow the whistle dead. I don't know if Kareem ever touched the turf, but I think maybe momentum had stopped him. They'll mark him at the 9, so all that for a gain of 1.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. I thought it looked like that was a quick whistle to me. I think that he still had a little bit of momentum going forward.
See, Kenai Kane check into the game. And again, Thomas Jefferson, we mentioned in Dr. Axe's injury report before kickoff that he's been dealing with a rib injury. So that's kind of the reason Thomas Jefferson has not been in the mix. Only a couple of carries over the last 2 weeks. So it's been Kane and Williams, and it'll look like, or at least early on, it's staying that way. Second down and 9. Ball on the 9. Caruso going to throw sideline for Jarman, just a bit out of reach at around the 35-yard line. It falls incomplete. Third and long now for the Hens.
All right. Well, there's our first attempt at making a little play downfield. There is a penalty flag to see what they're.
We'll hear from the official Kelvin Hudson on the call.
Personal foul. Roughing the passer on the defense number 99. That? Contact with the head and neck area of the quarterback. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. First down.
And that's the defenseman Gavin Johnson. And there you have another rookie mistake. He's he's a sophomore, but a young guy and making a mistake on J.P. Caruso. This is a William Mary team that does not get penalized very much. Just 6th in the nation. Fewest penalties per game on the season. So a costly one there. Would have been 3rd down and 9. Instead, 1st of 10 for Delaware at their own 24. It'll be Williams sprinting left side. And, wow, this William Mary defense has been swarming all over the football. The pickup of 1 to the 25.
Yeah, that's a good play there by them. Good block by number 77, actually. But they're swarming. Defense is swarming early on.
Doing a good job, the Tri-Bar. And this is a tough defensive team. Jimmy Laycock squad always solid on the defensive side. You always have to grind against William Mary's team. You know, Jimmy Laycock, he's been coaching for 38 years at William & Mary. That's impressive stuff.
Very impressive.
245 wins for the Tribe. Hens will try to keep it at that number today. 2nd down and 9. Some pressure on Caruso. He's looking for some room to run and nowhere to go. He's going to be dropped at the line of scrimmage, so it won't be a sack. He got up to the 25. Joe Suarez was there first, his 6th tackle of the season.
Yeah, not sure if that was by design or not, but it looked like Caruso was a little antsy there, a little jumpy. I don't know if he was supposed to, you know, look to run that ball, but it didn't look like he gave the guys enough time to get open.
Kenai Kane in as the runner on 3rd down and 9. It would have been 3rd down and 9 earlier on this drive if not for the Gavin Johnson late hit on J.P. Caruso. So now Delaware, who are 1 of 3 on 3rd down, will take the snap. It's Caruso. He fires over the middle, looking for Cherry, and just too far ahead of the senior wide receiver at the 30-yard line of William Mary. It falls incomplete, so we'll see Nick Pritchard once again to punt this one away.
Well, Well, one of my keys to the game was Cherry, and I think we had an opportunity there with him. That was a nice route that he ran. Caruso let the ball get away from him a little bit there.
Under a minute to play first quarter, and Caruso now 1 of 4 throwing the football for only 2 yards. Nick Pritchard punted the ball so well against Stony Brook. A big 60-yard punt at the end of the game against Stony Brook. And this one over the outstretched arms of William and Mary. And now Jalen Christian will wait for it at the 30-yard line with 50 seconds remaining in the first quarter. And not a whole lot of offense on either side. A 45-yard punt by Nick Pritchard. And we'll see William and Mary come on out onto the field once again. So Corey Nido said it in the pregame show, but if you're a fan of defense, this might be the game for you. Not much happening. We got two quarterbacks starting for the very first time and two very stout defenses out there on the field.
Yeah, a little slow going in the earlier parts here. I'd like to see a little bit more fireworks. You know, I'm an offensive guy. I want to see numbers.
You had some big numbers back in your day. That was all-time leader in receiving yards. Eddie Conti with me. I'm Scott Klatsky. Corey Nido on the sideline. Sean Mitchell is the quarterback for William & Mary, and he's going to give the football to another freshman, Nate Evans, starting to run wide. Cuts it back. John Nassib with the tackle at the 33-yard line. Gain of 3 on first down as the clock continues to tick away in the first quarter. No score. 38 seconds remain.
Another couple yards there. You know, William Mary's doing a good job running off tackle. They're picking up 3, 2, 3, 4 yards at a pop. There's another one, a decent first down run there. So let's see how that goes moving forward.
47 total yards now for William Mary, just 21 total yards for Delaware. And we're coming up on what might be the final play of the first quarter of action on second down and 7. Under center is Mitchell. In motion goes Daniel Kuzjak, the senior. He retraces to the left side. Play action. He wants to throw to Kuzjak. Not open. Now Troy Reeder putting pressure on Mitchell. Mitchell rolling out. Has to throw this one away, and he does so towards the Delaware bench. That's a nice job in coverage, but also in pursuit of the quarterback. Troy Reeder not giving up on the play.
Yeah, excellent job by Reeder there.
1 second on the clock. So this will officially be the final play of the first quarter coming up. No score. And unless William Mary strikes it big, it'll be nothing heading into quarter number 2. 7 yards to go for William & Mary as Nate Evans is the running back. Same to the left side of the freshman quarterback. Mitchell awaits the snap. Delaware, 3-down lineman. Backing off is Malcolm Brown in coverage. Here's Mitchell pumping, looking, trying to scramble. Flag is thrown. That's got to be a hold as Mitchell tries to run for the first down. He's going to be shy by about 3 yards. Blaine Woodson making the stop, and that's going to be a holding penalty against William & Mary, as there was just too much time for the quarterback, Mitchell, as Delaware was trying to come after him. Good pressure by that defensive line there. We'll hear the call from the referee once he turns his microphone on for us. There we go.
Holding on the offense, number 77. Death penalties declined. Fourth down. That's the end of the first quarter.
So that'll end quarter number 1 with a penalty that is declined. Fourth down coming up for William and Mary. And it's no score at the end of 1. It'll be fourth down coming up for the Tribe. And, you know, we've got an all-star up in the booth, an All-American up on the booth. And now down on the sideline, we've got an All-American as well, a former national champion. Corey Nido is with Pops, Mike Adams.
Thank you, Scott. Here with Mike Adams. Mike, good crowd here on hand. What makes it so special to play at Delaware Stadium?
It's always
rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
How do you show up? Do you just bring it? Or do you bring it all?
Focus.
Third row like a pro. Step up to GMC and get 4,000 purchase allowance on almost every 2017 GMC Acadia model when you finance through GM Financial. We are professional grade GMC. We'll be right back.
action here as we start the second quarter of football. William Mary punting it as they split sides of the field, and Jamie Jarman trying to get under it. He does so, going to try to return it. He breaks one at the 30, now running wide at the 35. Cuts it into a little bit of traffic at the 40-yard line, and the whole stadium should be getting up and cheering that one. Delaware last in the nation in punt return yardage, and Jamie Jarman giving it a try, picking up some yardage. Delaware negative 3 punt yards on the season prior to that one. Eddie, you are a big-time punt returner. What do punt returners need to do, and what does Delaware need to do to be able to return some more punts like that?
Well, I didn't get a chance to comment on his first attempt, which was I was very upset to see him not get up and catch the ball early on where he could have had the 18-yard line, and it ended up bouncing to the 8-yard line. He did a much better job there catching the ball and getting upfield.
We've got Joe Walker at quarterback. We've got J.P. Caruso split out to the left, and Walker going to take the snap and get up to the 45-yard line. So we knew this was going to be something in the arsenal of Delaware. We knew we weren't done seeing Joe Walker, such an athlete, and that's the first time they're utilizing Joe. He'll pop out of the game, but a carry for Joe getting up to the 45, a gain of 4 on first down. We're going to see that. That was interesting. It was actually JP split out and Walker at quarterback. We thought maybe the opposite would happen, but right there again, and Kenai Kane back in as the running back with Walker to the sideline. I'm sure we'll see more of that throughout, but that's a 4-yard pickup on first down to the Delaware 45. Kane gets the handoff. That's to be a tackle for loss. A loss of 1 by William and Mary.
Great penetration line. A little stumble from Caruso coming out. I don't think that really disrupt the timing or anything. I think it was just good penetration there on the defensive line.
Yeah, this is a defensive line that gets after it. 8 tackles for loss, almost 8.5 tackles for loss per game for William Mary. That's 10th best in the country, first best in the CAA, and they get one there. So Hens move backwards on second down after picking up 4 on first. It's 3rd down and 7. Ball at the Delaware 44-yard line. Tight trips to the left side. And J.P. Caruso going to roll that way. Looking for someone open. Throws over the middle. It's deflected and nearly caught by Cherry 10 yards up the field. But it falls to the turf. That's the second time we've seen a J.P. Caruso pass get deflected in a near interception by William and Mary. And Deontay Cherry at that point was almost playing like a cornerback, making sure he got to the ball and not allowing the INT.
Yeah, he did there. Good job reacting, getting back and breaking up that play.
So it's 4th down and 7, and Delaware continues to struggle offensively. Only 29 yards of total offense in this game.
Yeah, not too shocking, I don't think. You know, still trying to figure out things here with Caruso. And
JP now 1 of 5 for only 2 yards passing, though. He does lead the team with 12 rushing yards. Jalen Christian back to return as the Hens stall out offensively on a 3 and out. Nearly blocked. Pritchard gets a good one off, though. Waving for it at the 14-yard line is Jalen Christian. And back and forth we go. Nothing happening for either team offensively. A 42-yard punt by Nick Pritchard gives the football to William Mary. The Tribe 0-2 in the CAA, but they've had close ones. A 25-17 loss to the surprise of the year in the CAA, Elon. And then a week prior to that, on the road at Stony Brook, at home against Stony Brook, they fell 21-18. So this is a hungry William Mary team, and you're seeing it defensively. And right now, Delaware's got to get the offense going because you've got a freshman quarterback for William Mary. Early on, you want to build a lead against him because you don't want this guy to get into rhythm and feel some confidence.
Yeah, that's absolutely true. That's a heck of a punt there by our kid. Field position obviously is going to be a big part in this game.
Pritchard, one of the best, second in the CAA to John Hinchin at Villanova in yards per punt. Quarterback is still Mitchell. The running back is Albert Funderburk on first down and 10 from the William Mary 14. Kinder goes in motion, and Mitchell's on the run. Reeder trying to track him down. It's a sprint at the 15-yard line, and Reeder gets to him. The ball will be marked at the 16 as he got out of bounds. That's a fast linebacker, and Troy Reeder catching up with the QB.
I like what I'm seeing out of Reeder, man. That was just excellent. You know, he's full speed ahead. He looks good out there. He's a good-looking football player, and he plays with passion, and that was just a great play.
Reeder, 41 tackles on the season coming in. That's his 5th today. Leads the team in that category, and we'll see 2nd down and 8 for William Mary from their own 16 under center. Mitchell goes. Nick Wimmer will snap the football to him, and to the right side it goes to running back Funderburk. He is slammed for a loss. Colby Reeder, Troy Reeder, the brothers collapse to get the tackle for loss.
Don't you love that? The brother connection. I mean, it doesn't get any better than this. It really doesn't. This is really great to see, and just great plays by both of them. There they are, butting each other's helmet. What a great atmosphere this is, and this is excellent.
You know, that's why they came to Delaware, to make plays like that, to play together. Big offers from Colby Reader, Miami of Florida. He got offered by Syracuse. He would have been part of that team that beat Clemson last night.
Yeah, how about
if he
that?
So chose. But instead, they wanted to play together. We know Troy went to Penn State and now making the tackle together at Delaware. Third down and nine. And Mitchell's pass is deflected, nearly interception. A lot of tipped balls in this game. And a scary one for William & Mary. They get away with it. And another three and out, this time for the Tribe.
Good pressure there again by Reader. Good pressure right in the quarterback's face.
A lot of tip passes in this ball game, and not a whole lot of offense. Corey Nido was right when he said this might not be a game with a lot of offensive firepower.
Well, again, that punt we had was big. It set up the field position, and, you know, we're winning the field position battle, and we're going to get a good opportunity right here.
Yeah, big chance for good field position with that three and out by the defense is their punter will line up at the one-yard line on fourth down and nine. 11:50, second quarter, no score. And Mitchell gets this one away. It's low and returnable for Jarman at midfield. Breaks one at the 45. Breaks another. Still on his feet at the 40. And he spins down to the 37-yard line. Jamie Jarman, after not returning a lot of punts this year, didn't wave his hands that time. He got 12 yards on the punt.
I like to see that out of him. I really do. Not raving for that fair catch. Getting the ball. Getting upfield as quickly as possible. Breaking a couple tackles. It got the crowd a little bit amped up.
Yeah, these are smart fans we've got at Delaware. They know we've had some punt problems, and they appreciate what Jamie's doing. We're going to take a timeout. Still no score. That's your PNC Bank timeout score with 11:37 remaining in the second quarter.
The area's largest family-owned and operated.
The official bird of Delaware isn't red. It's not green or purple. It's blue. Coincidence? We think not. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield Delaware. This blue hen does not need to see a podiatrist. But if he did, waiting for a referral might get his feathers in a bunch. And he wouldn't like that one bit. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield Delaware.
Hi guys, it's great to be here.
In the desert.
At the mall.
On the mountain.
At school.
At the beach.
In the Big Easy.
Yeah.
Today I want to show you guys the next gen Chevy Equinox. What do you think?
That's pretty.
Pretty sexy.
It's all wheel drive, look at that.
It looks aggressive.
But not overbearing. It's not too big, not too small.
Looks like it could go off-roading.
But at the same time, it looks like a car you could take to a nice event.
You can it up or dress it down.
Seems like the perfect car for anybody.
I would take it anywhere.
I want one.
I love it.
She's a bad mamma jamma.
Chevy stepped their game up.
Score. Still waiting on one team to find the end zone or put some points on the board. Thank you, Corey, for that information. TJ Mangus at 28. He's got to be, what, 9 years older than his starting quarterback?
Good info there, Corey. That was interesting.
Joe Walker in as the quarterback. And we see JP Caruso split out to the left side. They'll give it to the runner, Thomas Jefferson, his first carry, and he stretches his way to the 33-yard line. That's a pickup of five on first down. So we continue for the second possession in a row to see Walker in as quarterback to start the drive.
I like to see that. You know, I was hoping we were going to see that. You know, we have such a great athlete in Walker there, and I was high on him. I know that he's gotten some balls have gotten away from him, but it's good to see him involved.
And we see Walker again at the quarterback spot. This time to the far side of the field is Caruso. Two wide receivers to the near side. Back split next to Joe on second down and five. This time Joe going to keep it. Looking for a seam. Not much there. Gets to the 31-yard line. It'll be third down and about three coming up for the Hens.
This is a great thing that we can do this now. You know, it definitely makes it a little bit more difficult for defenses to prepare. They have to prepare for another dynamic that, you know, quite frankly, could be very dynamic. You know, I think he's one of the best athletes on this field, if not the fastest guy that Delaware has in Walker. So if we can get him involved like we are, it'll be great.
We see 90 coming into the football game. That's David Kroll, So we'll keep an eye on him. First time I've called his name this season. That's a big boy right there on the far right side of the offensive line. Kenai Kane is the runner on third down and three. In motion goes Whaley, the tight end. Kane, the powerful runner, trying to dig his way for first down yardage. Second effort, I think, got him there. He was stuffed at the 30, drove his way to about the 28-and-a-half. It'll depend on the spot as Trey Watkins made the tackle. It looks like they're not going to get a friendly spot, though.
They didn't. They sure didn't. I thought that he could have been a tiny bit more patient in setting up that first block. I thought he hit it a little bit too soon, but then he did give a great second effort. He is a tough runner, but just a little bit more patience there, and I think he would have had an easy first down.
This will make the fans happy at Delaware Stadium. Looks like the offense is going to stay on the field, fourth and inches.
All right.
And we've got J.P. Caruso will line up under center. Yoakum is the fullback. Kenai Kane is the runner. Fourth and one for the Hens. Kane gets it to the left side, shoulder down. It's going to be close. There was a push. He got the first down yardage. The gamble on fourth down pays off, and the drive continues for the Hens.
I like that gamble. I really do. You know, it's a 0-0 game. There's nothing going on offensively. Let's get that first down, give our group a lot of confidence, get the fans excited, and let's build off of that.
That was just the second time Delaware has tried on fourth down to convert this season. Their first successful fourth down pickup of the year. And this is as deep into William Mary territory as Delaware's been all game long. Thomas Jefferson in as the runner on first and 10. 9:09, second quarter, no score. Ends with the football. And Caruso going to throw down the middle. Has Jarman for a touchdown. Four games in a row. Jamie's found the end zone, and the Hens get on the board first.
Attaboy. That's a great job by Caruso. I was worried for 1 second there he wasn't going to see Jarman streaking down the middle of the field wide open. I saw it immediately, and credit to Caruso. He saw him and threw a perfect strike. Great job. Great catch by number six there, and here we go.
Some excitement. It comes at 9:01 left in the second quarter. A nice route by Jarman, and J.P. Caruso, who was just one of five before that toss, finds Jamie for 27 yards. And the score, Frank Rago on for the extra point. Pritchard will hold for Rago, who's been red hot kicking the football. Snap from Sheets, and the PAT is through. 7-0, Delaware leads over William & Mary. 9:01 remaining in the second quarter. That's your PNC Bank timeout score.
International Brotherhood.
this one away. Jake Roth, 22 kickoffs this season. 13 of them have been unreturnable. One has sailed out of bounds, and he'll kick towards the north side of the field for the first time today. Looks like Jalen Christian is back deep to return. Jake Roth gets this one up, and Christian going to be able to return it from the 4-yard line near side of the field to the 10, 15-yard line, now 20. Pushes his blocker ahead, and down he goes at the 22-yard line. And that's Tenny Adewusi, who came sprinting through to make the stop. William and Mary will get onto the field. And, Corey, you're down there on the sideline, and there was one happy camper in particular for the Hens after that touchdown.
Yes, sir, Scott. It was J.P. Caruso. He jumped up so high, getting the crowd amped up, raising both his arms, trying to elevate this crowd noise. And he is certainly the spark plug that Coach Rocco has been talking about. He's cheering everybody on here on the sidelines, giving them hats on the back, on the helmet. He wants to win this ball game, and he's certainly showing it to his teammates.
He's 1-0 as he came in and won that football game against Stony Brook, and now has a lead in the first half of football. 8:55, second quarter. William Mary back on the field. Ball on their own 21-yard line with Mitchell as the quarterback. Play action. He's got time to throw. Will do so. Down the middle of the field, has a streaking wide receiver. Great defense by Tenny Adewusi. He just made the play on special teams, and that time knocked it away from the intended receiver, Zach Burdick.
What a great, great, great play by that guy right there. I'm telling you, that was a beautiful ball by the quarterback. The wide receiver had it in his sights, and he reached over with one hand, gave up his body, and made an incredible play.
Now, you're absolutely right. That ball was on point. If Tenny Adewusi is not right there step for step, that would have been a big pickup for the redshirt freshman. Instead, it's back to 2nd and 10 for William and Mary. And the give is to the running back, Evans. And John Nassib with a tackle for a loss back at the 19. Nassib getting the start as a senior for the injured Cam Kitchen, as he has made the most of his additional time out there on the football field. Two tackles for loss on the season. He gets a third.
It's a fun defense to watch.
Yeah.
Very reminiscent of the 1997 defense we had, which was one of the better defenses in the country that year. And, you know, these guys remind me a lot of that team.
Man, there's been a lot of great defenses here. We talked to Pops. He was part of one in 2003. And this one could be one for the ages as well. Third down and 11 for William & Mary. Ball on their own 20-yard line. 8:08 and ticking second quarter. Nassib, some pressure. Swing pass is caught by Evans. Nowhere to run, and he is brought down by Troy Reeder. What a tackle by the junior.
Look at the excitement. Look at the excitement. Boy, I really love it. Great job by Troy Reeder there. He is a tough, tough guy.
Corey, you were right there. What'd you say on that tackle?
I saw an animal, Scott. Literally just ripped him down with one arm around the shoulder pads and then grabbed him by the jersey. That basically was a fingertip tackle as they're playing out on the video board. And then he comes up with a big celebration. This Blue Hens team is certainly feeling it now.
They're fired up, and that's the second week in a row. Troy Reeder's made a one-arm tackle, stopping a runner in its tracks. Jamie Jarman not going to return this one, waving for it at the William Mary 48-yard line. And we're going to take a timeout after a 31-yard punt by Will Michaels. 7:17 to go in the first half of football. Hens lead at 7-0. That's your PNC Bank timeout score.
This is Dr. Michael Axe at First.
they'll give it to the wide receiver. Jarman runs into Charles Scarf wide on the right side of the field, and he picks up four to the William & Mary 48-yard line. Atkins, another tackle for William & Mary, but it looks like Scarf kind of impeded his movement there for a moment, and he had to slow up.
Yeah, I thought Jarman had an opportunity to hit it, get upfield a little bit quicker than he did. He second-guessed himself, but just on pure basic second effort, he was able to pick up a few yards.
Jamie Jarman, his third carry of the season, leads the team with 16 catches coming in. His 17th was good for 7 points. Second down and five, and the lone back is Kareem Williams. He'll get it. Has a hole at the 45. It closed quickly as he goes down at the 43-yard line. Shy of the first down marker, but the third down and short for Delaware. Aaron Swinton, the defensive captain, flying in and making the stop.
Yeah, good job. Good quick hit in the hole there by the running back. And almost popped one there.
He did. That's what Coach Rocco is looking for these running backs to do. Put together a home run hit. Mm-hmm. And right now on third down and one, Delaware has it at the Tribe 43-yard line. Kareem Williams is the running back. He stands behind Caruso, and he's going to get the give to the left side. And William & Mary all over it. Josh Delaney coming in late, but Corey Parker got there first. And Kareem Williams, maybe a loss of a half of a yard. It'll be fourth down and close. Now Delaware converted on what was fourth down and one. And now decision time as the ball is towards the middle of the field as fourth down and two. And it looks like the Hens are going to try again. Fourth down and two, a long two, almost three for Delaware as Williams will stay in. Hens are one of one today on fourth down at the Tribe 44-yard line. Caruso, hard count, trying to get some movement on William & Mary. Three tight ends all go in motion to the left side. And Caruso just trying to get the Tribe offsides, it looks like.
Almost had him there. It's a good idea. It's a good job there. Went for early fourth down.
Offense, number nine, the 5-yard penalty. It remains fourth down.
A very disciplined William & Mary team, though. That's a good idea. Obviously, why not? Pritchard, you just give him more room to punt the football. So, really, no matter for Delaware moving back a couple yards on the penalty. But William & Mary, as I mentioned, 10th in the FCS football with only 4.5 penalties per game. So, a very disciplined squad there and a good job by the Tribe, not the Joe. Nice job by Mike Diodati on this there. We got a good sound coming from J.P. Caruso on those hard counts. Christian back to return, and Nick Pritchard gets a snap from Tim Sheridan. It's high. Christian under it at the nine. Makes a move, and Buck Jones is there, tackling him for a loss of one. Back to the 8-yard line. Flying through was Ray Jones after a 37-yard punt. Phenomenal special teams coverage today by the Hens.
Excellent job. Excellent job. All three phases of the game so far, you know, special teams is right up there as important as defense and offense. So that was a great play by that kid. And again, here we are. We got them pinned inside the 15-yard line. Excellent job.
And it seems like William & Mary has been on this side of the field the entire first half. This defense allowing only 48 total yards of this William & Mary offense. The freshman, Sean Mitchell, underneath center. Funderburk is the running back. On the offset eye, he gets the give. Starts up center, cuts to the left side. Anthony Jackson meets him at the 16.5-yard line. Will be second down and about six to go.
Yeah, another pretty good first down game there by William & Mary. Running the ball, good cutback by that kid. And picked up some good yardage.
William & Mary averaging start position their own 21-yard line. 4:19 to go in the first half of football. Delaware has a 7-0 lead. And out of shotgun is Mitchell on second down and six from his own 16. In motion goes Christian. They give it to the running back instead. It's Funderburk, lowers his head, and down he goes at the 19.5, a pickup of three. It'll quickly be third down for the Tribe. And William & Mary, 0 of 5 on third down conversions today. See an injured player down on the field. Looks like Malcolm Brown slow to get up. Newark urgent care injury stoppage as Danny Rocco comes out onto the field to check on Malcolm Brown. Don't go anywhere at the half. It was Benny Pinella. We'll be back in the studio. We'll have scores from around college football. And we'll also have Corey Nido talk to Coach Rocco on his way into the locker room. And cornerback is not a spot that Delaware can have any more injuries. We started the year with Justin Watson, unfortunately injuring himself for the year. Malcolm Brown, he was pivotal in that Stony Brook game, getting the fumble recovery for a touchdown and really turning the tide against the Seawolves. And now a redshirt junior in his fourth year with the program. He is up and walking. We'll have Corey keep an eye on Malcolm as he gets to the sideline. But a good sign, he is up and moving on his own to get to the sideline.
Yeah, good to see that. You know, big thing is injuries. The role that they play in any season, any year, any season that I can recall that we had a great year, you look back on it, it was very limited in injuries. So very, very important. Good to see him up and moving around.
Dan Watson, the trainer, his 13th season. Brandon DeSantis, and of course, Dr. Andrew Reisman in his 11th year, helping out Malcolm Brown. Third down and two for William and Mary. Down 7-0, just under 4 minutes to play, second quarter. Mitchell, quick pass, is caught in traffic by Daniel Kuzjak for a first down yardage at the 27. Colby Reeder was there, and that was a tight window for the freshman to toss it through.
That was a tight window. He looked confident with that throw, and I got to say, that was a really, really good snag by that kid using his hands and making that catch to moving the sticks. Big deal there.
7 of 11 now is Sean Mitchell. Not a whole lot of yardage, though. Some easy tosses prior to that one. Got him to 31 yards. Again, William & Mary just 63 yards of offense in this game. They'll go out of the pistol, setting a man in motion on first and 10 from their own 27-yard line. Give it to the freshman running back, Nate Evans. He skips, gets the line of scrimmage, and falls forward to the 29-yard line. A pickup of two as Reeder and Bilal Nichols get out of the pile last. Clock approaching 3 minutes. Nate Evans, a good story. Well, depends. Good for who you ask, but good for William & Mary. He was reportedly going to Richmond to play for Coach Danny Rocco, and then Coach Rocco obviously came here. And Evans, a Virginia native, decided to switch sides and play for William & Mary. Have a good start to his career. Now second down and 7. He stands next to the quarterback at the 30-yard line of the Tribe. Sean Mitchell looking, has all day. Finds his running back, but there's a drop pass by Evans, who was a bit off balance, backpedaling at the 33-yard line. That'll bring up third down and 7 for the Tribe, but another drop pass this time on the side of William & Mary.
Yeah, good to see for us, you know, to be on the other side of the ball that time. Good job out of quarterback there, I thought, to be patient, you know, look down, check down, saw his third receiver wide open there in the middle, threw a good strike, and the kid dropped the ball on him.
Only the fifth incomplete pass by Sean Mitchell. Here we are on third down for the Tribe, just 1 of 6 on third down in this ball game. And that conversion came just moments ago. Third and 7. Mitchell towards the Delaware sideline. Too wide for Daniel Kuzjak. Incomplete. And the punt unit will come on board. Another great job by the defense of holding strong and sending their punter, Will Michael, out onto the field.
Great job again. Great job again by the defense. Gave a couple, like we said. But, you know, stiffened up when it mattered. I thought that wide receiver there came a little bit slow out of his break. The quarterback, I did think, threw a good ball. Wide receiver did a good job getting to the first down yardage, but getting to the markers, but then a little bit slow out of his cut.
Jamie Jarman back to return for Delaware. He's had a good day today, all things considered. Delaware native 3 yards, and there's a flag before the punt. Will Michael will send it. It'll bounce at the 40-yard line, and out of bounds it goes in Delaware territory. We'll hear the call from the official.
Yeah, it looks like our guy there on the left side jumped off sides, possibly.
Well, it's fourth down and 7, though.
Right.
So we'll hear the penalty from the head official, Kelvin Hudson. Hudson's still waiting. A lot of talking by these referees today. Here we go.
Offsides on the defense, number 20. That's a 5-yard penalty that'll be tacked on at the end of the run. First down.
So Delaware's offense coming out on the field with 2:24 left to play in this first half of football. And the Hens up 7-0.
Yeah.
Haven't seen a whole lot of offense from either team. 76 yards by the Blue Hens, 66 for William & Mary.
Yeah, slow going. Definitely slow going. Looks like both teams are still trying to find their footing here offensively. So let's see what happens here moving forward.
All right, Delaware is trying to get some sound back on the field. There we go. Lost that for a second. Michael Bommel doing a great job up top, making sure we got some sound back. Mike Diodati down on the field and working through some things. And now that sounds good. You got a lot of fans here today. We want to hear them, and now we can. So Delaware coming out on offense, 2:24 remaining in the first half, and this will be huge, Eddie. If you can get a score here and go up by 2 possessions heading in the locker room, that'll be big for the Hens.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth, Scott. I agree with you. To get a couple more points here, you know, our defense is playing so solid. Just give us a little bit more cushion would be great.
Hens will start at their own 39-yard line with Corey Spruill, the true freshman, as the running back. Pressure comes for Caruso. He dumps it off for Spruill, but he set up his freshman running back. He gets hit hard as he catches the football for a loss of what will be about 4 yards on the play, as the linebacker read it properly, and Josh Delaney came in and got another tackle for loss. He leads the team with now 9 on the year.
Yeah, I don't know. That to me looked a little bit like it was slow developing also. I don't know if that was supposed to be a little bit quicker strike there, but gave that linebacker a little bit too much time to get right in his face.
Second down and 14, loss of 4. J.P. Caruso out of shotgun. Crisscross play goes to Spruill. Spruill again in trouble, this time a loss of 5, back to the 30. And Delaware going backwards on what could be their final drive of the first half.
Yeah, we got to be careful here. A minute and 36 seconds to go. You know, we don't want to give William and Mary the ball back and give them the opportunity now. With they're getting good field position and getting some points here at the right before the end of the half.
That's
and
true.
Take the wind out of our sails just a hair.
Both teams have 3 timeouts remaining. So if William and Mary does get the football back and can put together a drive, possibility for a touchdown or a field goal, if they can get in position and use the clock wisely. Kane is the running back on third down and 18 as Caruso will roll out. Looking towards the sideline, throws to Cherry, who catches it at the 39-yard line. That was the original line of scrimmage, so they get 8 yards back, but it'll be a 3-and-out for Delaware with 1:03 remaining, and because Cherry went out of bounds, that clock stops as well.
Yeah,
almost a free timeout for William & Mary.
You're exactly right. It was exactly right. It was a good job by Cherry, a good route, and a good throw by Caruso. Gets us back another 8 yards, and hopefully we can pin them here with a big punt.
Jalen Christian back to return. Delaware's had fantastic special teams play thus far in the first half. Here's Pritchard. William & Mary was coming after it that time. Christian under it at the 22. He's going to run and run nowhere. As again, Tenny Adewusi is there for his second punt tackle of the game. And wow, he was all over it after a 46-yard punt by Nick Pritchard. I know you like that, Eddie.
Oh, that's beautiful. This kid's got a nice leg, our punter. He's really hitting the ball really well, and that was just a big, big job there with 54 seconds left. If we didn't have them, forced to go 85 yards to get points, field goal, a little bit less than that, that can't be understated how important that it was.
Yeah, Pritchard last week with a 60-yard punt, which made Stony Brook have to march 91 yards if they wanted to win the ball game. And Delaware and Stony Brook needed every one of those 91 yards. Were unable to get there, and on fourth down, a sack by Blaine Woodson ended up finalizing the game. So Pritchard has been big in his first year after transferring from Maryland. Sean Mitchell is the quarterback again for William & Mary on first down. Hole opens for Funderburk as he gets to the 21-yard line. Colby Reeder on the tackle. 6-yard pickup. Clock will run at 44 seconds, and William & Mary looks like they're not in a hurry. They're not going to use the timeout here, so they're happy with being down just 7 heading into the locker room with only 66 yards of total offense. Mitchell taps his feet, nearly intercepted. It is Colby Reeder with the INT, and Delaware with 26 seconds left in the first half, a chance to score again before heading into the locker room.
Woo, what a big play there. Great, great anticipation by number 23. Got his finger on the ball, tip drill, and that's what we want to see. Excitement, and now here we go. We got a chance to get some more points on the board before half.
How about that? Looked like William & Mary was playing conservatively, not going to use their timeouts, and instead of running the football, getting into the locker room, you now are already in Frank Rago field goal range, and with 3 timeouts and 26 seconds, Delaware going to have some chances to put 7 on the board.
Absolutely devastating for William & Mary, and equally as great here for Delaware.
See if the Hens can get points off of the turnover. The running back is Kenai Kane from the 18-yard line in the red zone. Caruso pumps, he's hit, there's a flag, he spins out of it momentarily, but brought down by Bill Murray, the sophomore from New Jersey, back in the 22. It looks like Delaware's going to be called for a hold there. So not the way you want to start that drive after the turnover.
On the offense, number 54, just a 10-yard penalty. Replay, first down, Delaware, timeout.
So the Hens will take a timeout here, but that's a big penalty because you were inside the red zone and you were certainly within field goal range of Frank Rago. And now you're right on the cusp. Obviously, a guy that knocked in a 50-yarder for against Stony Brook and a 55-yarder on the other side of the field a couple weeks back has is still within range, but you're right on the edge right now at first and 20 instead of first and 10 from the 18.
Yeah, no doubt about it. A costly and untimely penalty. You know, it takes possibly takes 6-7 points out of the equation. But you said it. This kid has a super strong leg. And, if we can just get a few more yards here, we can still get the 3 points, which would be, as we spoke about earlier, crucial going into halftime.
So it'll be interesting to see if Delaware tries to run the football and just gain a couple and put Frank Rago in position to get a field goal, or if they go for it, try to pass the football and try to get six on the board. Looks like they're going to go for option number two as they spread out. J.P. Caruso in the backfield by himself. Pressure coming. He throws, batted down again. Bill Murray's having quite the day. Tackle for loss a moment ago and got his hands on that football. So now third down and 20, 15 seconds left. You have two timeouts, Delaware does, so you can still take a shot here before setting it up for Frank Rager.
Yeah, big play right there, him getting his hands on the ball because Jamie Jarman ran a little skinny post route and was wide open, and Caruso saw him and was going to throw that ball, the kid knocking it down. That was a big play.
Again, empty backfield for J.P. Caruso. Two wide receivers to both sides. J.P. on second down and 20 from the Tribe 28. He throws, passes caught at the 19-yard line by Jarman. He'll be down there. Rayshon Smith with the tackle. Delaware will call timeout with 8 seconds left. It'll be third down for Delaware, but you have enough time to run a play here. It's third down and 10, and you have one timeout left, so you have enough time to try for the end zone before sending Frank Bracco out, if you want.
I think so. I think the move here is, if you're going to run another play, you know, what's another 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 yards going to do? I think if they're going to do this, maybe one shot to the end zone, is the move.
But it's got to be quick. Usually 7 seconds on the clock is the cusp of where maybe you don't have enough time. Now at 8 seconds, it looks like Coach Rocco is going to send his quarterback back out there for one more try.
I think that it's going to be something in the seam, you know, a quick hitting strike, a quick strike and seam route, or a skinny post like they were going to try a little bit earlier. One step, two step drop, release, get the ball, maybe break a tackle, get in the end zone. If not, we got to get down and get that timeout.
So Delaware with a new personnel group, as we'll see Gene Coleman in, wearing a number 19, Vinny Papali out there. He's going to stand on the side with Cherry, split out to the far side right. On the left side is Jamie Jarman, third down and 10. Delaware up by 7, 8 seconds left. Caruso tosses towards the end zone, and catch is made out of bounds by Gene Coleman.
Pass interference call, I'm pretty sure.
They dropped the hat. I thought it was a flag as well, but they dropped the hat, marking Coleman out of bounds and thus ineligible.
Oh, that's what it was. Okay.
So instead of a shot at a touchdown, Delaware will send the field goal unit now. But I like the strategy there. Give it a shot, give it a try. Still got 4 seconds left, and now Frank Rago can end the half with a field goal. This one going to be 35 yards.
Well within his range. Chip shot for this guy. Let's get the 3 points and get into halftime.
Rago's been red hot. One of two kickers in the FCS with two kicks over 50 yards. And Jimmy Laycock going to try to ice him a little bit. No one's been able to ice Frank Rago over the past couple of weeks. Only Colin Root of Northern Colorado has had a longer field goal made this year at 56 yards than Frank Rago's 55-yarder he hit against James Madison. So 4 seconds left, and Delaware up 7-0, a chance to go up by 2 scores heading into the locker room. And we're seeing on the big board here, the catch was made out of bounds by Gene Coleman.
What a great catch by Coleman.
It was a nice grab. It
what
won't
a
count
great
for anything,
catch, man. It doesn't count for a thing, but boy, that's a nice job by him.
The freshman Gene Coleman, everyone high on him, 4 catches already on the season. So he'll have a good career, we hope, here at Delaware. Don't tune us out once we go to the halftime, because Benny Pinella's got the IBEW Local 313 halftime report. Also, before heading into the locker room, Corey Nido will talk with head coach Danny Rocco and get his thoughts on what has been a defensive battle heading into the second half. Frank Rago and a whistle.
The game clock. Please reset the play clock to 25 seconds. Start the play clock on my signal.
How about that? The official kind of icing the kicker there. Frank Rago was ready to kick this one away. And the crowd not liking it, with good reason. Kelvin Hudson, the official, as Frank Rago was lining up and getting ready to go, stops it to reset the play clock, which wasn't in play. Delaware was ready to snap the football. And then Jimmy Laycock, a double timeout to make Frank Rago think of it a little more. But Frank is a veteran, and it'll be hard to ice. And, you know, he's done very well over his career, 69% field goals, 24 of 35 career this season, 2 of 3 from 20 to 29 yards. He's made both his kicks from inside 39 or between 30 and 39 yards.
Yeah, I don't think it shouldn't be a problem. I never really could understand the whole icing concept. These kickers are so skilled at what they do. It's a 3 steps to the back, 2 steps to the left, you know, nod your head and go. It's routine, so it shouldn't be a problem.
Sheets will snap it. Pritchard will hold. Frank Rago from 35 yards to give Delaware a 2-possession lead. Heading into locker room, it's through. And the Hens lead 10-0 at the break.
There you go. Great job.
Frank Rago, like you said, Eddie, unfazed by the icing of the kicker. Double timeout by Jimmy Laycock, and the Hens take advantage of what was a risky play by William Mary, throwing the football instead of just taking a couple runs in the locker room. They put the ball in the air, and it was intercepted after a tip pass by Colby Reeder. A couple plays later, a Delaware on the board with a field goal to end the first half. And we've got Danny Rocco coming Corey Nido's away. This interview at the half presented by Rufo Associates. Visit RufoLaw.com. We'll send it to Corey.
All right, thanks, Scott. Coach, you guys were able to just pick up a field goal there right before the first half. Overall, a defensive game. What does your team need to do to focus on to try and pad this lead in the second half?
Well, you know, we're sitting here at 10-0, so, I mean, to be quite frank with you, I'd end it right now, and I'd be happy, okay? So defense is playing really well. Special teams is playing really well. Really big kick right there with Frank. So we've had one or two productive drives in the game. I know that JP made a good throw for touchdown there to Jamie, but, again, just, you know, too inconsistent, both in a run game and in a pass game. Now, they are good on defense. I knew going in today that this is a very good William & Mary defense, but we're going to have to finish our drives. We're going to have to get some more scores here in the second half.
Coach, thanks for your time.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Scott, Eddie, back up to you.
All right, thank you so much, Corey. I bet with that same sentiment, Stony Brook probably wishes they could have ended things after one half a week ago against Delaware. That's why you play two. Delaware's got to keep things going in the second half. Maybe find some spark offensively. Only 76 yards for Delaware on offense and 66 for Tribe. Unofficial as I look at the stat screen here that might need some updating. We are going to take a timeout. When we come back, it'll be the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, Local 313 halftime report. Benny Pinella back in the WDSD studios at the break. Delaware 10, Tribe nothing.
Come experience a new direction in healthcare. Star Health at the University of Delaware. Star Health offers.
Scott Klatskin, Eddie Conti, and Corey Nido on the call live from Delaware Stadium. The Hens up 10-0 at the half, and here is how they got there. So UD, they won the coin toss, elected to kick, so the Tribe, they would start us off from their 25-yard line, but wouldn't move the rock past the 50, picking up the two first downs before hitting that wall that is the UD defense. The Hens, they wouldn't fare much better on their first drive. Working to the 45 from the 12, Caruso looked good. Pair of scrambles, but dropped passes would hurt UD on this one. From the 45, UD would have to punt. Prior to the game, speculation was rampant over who would be the Tribe's QB. Tommy McKee was pulled from their last game. Brandon Battle came in, but neither getting the nod today. With William and Mary, he rolled with third-string freshman quarterback Sean Mitchell, who had it going early. During the Tribe's second drive, Mitchell connected with Jack Armstrong for a fresh set of downs to the 34. William and Mary would lean on Nate Evans, who clipped off two runs of 13 yards. And suddenly the Tribe, they were in Blue Hen territory. But their drive would come to an end at the 43 with a big Blue Hen stop.
Wide receivers to his right. And he's going to pass. Here comes Colby Reeder, flushing out of pocket. He throws on the run to the far sideline. Pass is caught, but down he goes. That is a one-on-one tackle by Nasir Adderley. He had the tight end Tyler Clausen brought him down shy of the marker.
Will Michael nailed a perfect 36-yard punt, pinning UD at their 8-yard line following that drive. But the first penalty of the day, a big one, 15 yards, roughing the passer. Helps UD get some breathing room to the 25. But again, both these teams, they may have some QB conundrums, but they certainly cannot say the same about their defense. The Tribe matching UD drive for drive. William and Mary got one final drive in before the quarter from the 30. It would travel only 3 yards before facing a 4th-and-7. But first, that was the end of the opening quarter. Second quarter starts with a punt. Solid return by Jamie Jarman to the UD 41. Some intriguing play calling to open up the drive. Walker comes in. Caruso lined up outside as a quarter. Instead of being a quarterback, it was a quarterback run for Walker. He gets UD about 4 yards, but a new look for UD nonetheless. However, the offensive struggles continued. Kenai Kane stuffed for a loss of one, and a deep pass attempt to Jarman would get batted away. Punts coming in troves for both teams. William and Mary going 3 and outs, then a bad punt. UD, good return for Jamie Jarman. And the Hens set up in stellar field position at the Tribe 38. Thomas Jefferson starts UD off with a solid run of 5 yards. Walker comes back in to get two. Kenai Kane would slam forward for two. But if you do the math, 5 plus 2 plus 2, that's only 9 yards. Need 10 for a first down. So with 4th and 1 from the William & Mary 29, UD would go for it.
This will make the fans happy at Delaware Stadium. Looks like the offense is going to stay on the field. 4th and inches.
All right.
And we've got J.P. Caruso will line up under center. Yoakum is the fullback. Kenai Kane is the runner. 4th and 1 for the Hens. Kane gets it to the left side, shoulder down. It's going to be close. There was a push. He got the first down yardage. The gamble on 4th down pays off, and the drive continues for the Hens.
That conversion would be huge for UD because one play later, the Hens finally broke it open.
Hens with the football. And Caruso, going to throw down the middle, has Jarman for a touchdown. 4 games in a row, Jamie's found the end zone, and the Hens get on the board first.
Delaware is loving its JP and Jamie show. 2 straight games, these two have connected for a score for Jarman. That's 4 straight games, he found the end zone. UD up 7-0 with 9 minutes left in the first half. UD's defense just swarming. Too much for the Tribe to handle.
Hens with the football. Ball on their own 21-yard line with Mitchell as the quarterback. Play action. He's got time to throw. Will do so. Down the middle of the field. Has a streaking wide receiver. Great defense by Tenny Adewusi. Just made the play on special teams, and that time knocked it away from the intended receiver, Zach Burdick. Ball on their own 20-yard line. 8:08 and ticking second quarter. Nassib, some pressure. Swing pass is caught by Evans. Nowhere to run, and he is brought down by Troy Reeder. What a tackle by the junior.
William & Mary was 0 for 4 on third downs at that point. 52 total yards and a whole lot of frustration for William & Mary's coach, Jimmy Laycock. UD, they get good field position again, starting at the Tribe 43. However, they couldn't duplicate their success from the previous drive, and UD would have to punt. Field position today was just so valuable for both teams. William & Mary starting out on average from their 21-yard line. When you've only got 67 yards on six drives, you're not going far. Neither was the Tribe on drive number six, only collecting 18 yards to get it to the 30 before having to punt. UD would go three and out quickly, so William & Mary taking over from their 15 when they would commit the first turnover of the game.
Mitchell taps his feet, nearly intercepted. It is Colby Reeder with the INT, and Delaware with 26 seconds left in the first half, a chance to score again before heading into the locker room.
A big turnover for the Tribe. UD with 26 seconds left in the William & Mary 18. A holding penalty would back the Blue Hens up 10 yards to the 28. That's when Caruso would connect to Mr. Reliable Jamie Jarman to get those 10 yards back. And with 4 seconds left, UD sent Frank Rago out to attempt a 35-yard field goal.
Sheets will snap it. Pritchard will hold. Frank Rago from 35 yards to give Delaware a 2-possession lead. Heading into locker room, it's through. And the Hens lead 10-0 at the break.
UD would take a 10-0 lead into the half. The Hens looking to build on it. They will receive the ball in the second half. When we come back, we'll take a look at what's going on around the CAA. Also, college football and Major League Baseball. The playoffs underway. It's up next on the IBEW Local 313 Halftime Show.
The International Brotherhood of Electrical.
Presented by the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers Local 313 and its local contractors.
Welcome back to the IBEW Local 313 Halftime Show. Benny Pinello. We're going to send it back to Scott Kladskin and Eddie Conti and Corey Nido in just a little bit. Right now, though, it's time to take a look at what's happening in the CAA. James Madison University, of course, they beat the Hens earlier this season, and they're currently beating Villanova 13-0 at the half. That matchup in Harrisonburg, Virginia, 1-11. Rhode Island trailing Maine at the halftime. Somebody's O has got to go there. Maine 0-3 in the CAA. Rhode Island 0-2 at the half, 23-21 in favor of the Black Bears. Richmond with 9:33 left in the second quarter. They are leading Towson 14-0, and Stony Brook versus New Hampshire has yet to get underway. FBS top 10 action, Alabama, Arkansas, Georgia, Missouri, Washington, Arizona, Ohio State, Nebraska have yet to get underway. But Wisconsin versus Purdue, well, number 7 team is leading that one. Wisco up 17-3. Auburn leading the Tigers of LSU 23-7. And TCU fighting that lightning delay earlier in the day. They're leading Kansas 13-3. In Major League Baseball action, the Yankees and Astros in the third. That one tied 0-0. Luis Severino versus Justin Verlander. For that one, Cubs versus Dodgers. That one getting ready to go underway. First pitch at 8:08. Jose Quintana versus Clayton Kershaw. Of course, the Flyers will face the Capitals later today. Flyers 2-2-0 with 4 points on the season. The Capitals 3-1-1 with 7 points on the season. Well, that does it here for myself, the IBEW Local 313 Halftime Show. We're going to send it back to Scott Kladskin, Corey Nido, and Eddie Conti in the booth. Coming up in a little bit, UD leading William & Mary, the Tribe, 10-0 at the half. You're listening to Blue Hens Game Day.
This has been the Blue Hens Halftime Report.
know, and get out of here. It doesn't have to be pretty. Not all wins are pretty. So let's just continue to do what we've been doing, build on the positives that we've had, and get out of here with a W.
All right, Delaware won the toss originally. They deferred to the second half for this reason. They scored to end the first half. They can now score on back-to-back possessions if they can do so here, as Gene Coleman is back to return the kickoff from Chris Hooper. First time we're seeing Chris Hooper with the ball teed up, and we are underway in the second half of football. This one sailing into the end zone, and Coleman going to take it out from about a yard deep to the 10-yard line, middle of the field, 15 sprinting, hit his leg at the 20-yard line, and he's pushing the pile ahead to the 25, so just as good as a touchback for Gene Coleman with a 25-yard return. Delaware's offense will come out onto the field led by J.P. Caruso, who has 43 yards passing and a touchdown in the first half.
All right, let's see if we could pick things up here, get some fireworks going, limit the drops, and big play here on first down to set up, open up the playbook there on second down and see if we can make something happen.
Yeah, you mentioned the drops on that opening drive. We saw two of them from Charles Scarf, so hopefully the Delaware can find a little bit more rhythm on the opening drive of the second half. The runner is Kareem Williams, 14:55, third quarter, hands up, 10-0. And the first snap of the second half is a rollout on the bootleg. Caruso finds Whaley, who has some room to run at the 30, near the sideline at the 40-yard line. First down pickup as Corey Parker and Aaron Swinton knock Whaley out of bounds. And good to see the senior from Haymarket, Virginia, get a first down pickup, 16 yards.
Good play there. Good call for first down. Misdirection. Picked up 11, 12, 13, 14 yards, whatever it is. And good decision, good call moving here in the first play of the second half.
Yeah, dumping it off to a tight end seems to have worked. Mentioned Scarf a couple of targets and come away with the catches, but that time Brandon Whaley with his fifth catch of the season. Whaley, a former All-CAA selection as a sophomore. First and 10, Delaware at their own 41-yard line. Gave us to the running back, Kareem Williams, looking for some space, and I got to give a lot of credit to this defensive line of William & Mary. They have not allowed much from the running backs of Delaware. One-yard pickup for Kareem Williams. It'll be second and 9.
Yeah, I'm really surprised William & Mary 2-3, you know, with this defense, the way they're playing.
It's a real solid defense, and now we'll see, again, Joe Walker in the huddle, J.P. Caruso getting the call from the sideline. It's second down and 9. This is the third time Joe Walker has been in the ball game. The first two times, Caruso has been split out to the left or right, and this time Caruso near the Delaware sideline, back split next to Joe Walker, a familiar position for him. A three-year starter, Joe Walker, sends Caruso in motion, trips to the outside right, and Walker will run the football. Gets a block from Jefferson, midfield, head down, and he's pushed out at the 47-yard line in tribe territory. We see the speed, the quickness of Joe Walker, an 11-yard pickup, and another first down on the opening drive.
Great job. Yeah, good blocking out there. Good patience by Walker, and a quick hit to the hole. And we're seeing, he could be electric. He really can. He's a big. He could play a big role in this game and move it forward for the rest of the season.
Great blocks by those running backs in Williams and Kane. Now, Kareem Williams, the runner, on first and 10 in tribe territory. Kareem gets hit at the 45-yard line. Down he goes at the 44. Plenty of white jerseys in the area. Delaware struggling to get that push against a strong defensive line. Kareem Williams rotating as a running back with Kenai King.
There's no need to be in a hurry here. You know, the clock is our friend at this time, at this moment. So let's wind it down, grind them, and keep moving forward here.
Yeah, maybe try to get this defense tired, keep them on the field. Delaware was one of the leaders in the country in time of possession to start the year, still top 20 team in that category as we're five games in. Crisscross goes to Kareem Williams on the carry to the 42-yard line. It'll be third down after a two-yard pickup. Third and 5 coming up for Delaware. Lots of misdirection today for Delaware, and we saw it that time.
Well, you know, I'm used to seeing that with University of Delaware going back to my days. You know, it's nice to see a little bit of misdirection every now and then. That's what we built our whole offense was built on back then.
You guys crossed up a lot of people.
Sure did.
Back in the 90s when you were playing and under Tubby Raymond. 12 minutes to go, third quarter, opening drive for Delaware. Empty backfield on third down and 5 for Caruso. Two wide receivers on both sides. Caruso hit as he throws it, diving. Deontay Cherry cannot come up with it at the 32-yard line. Armin Jones was coming in on a line to J.P. Caruso. He had to get rid of that thing, and it was just off the mark to Cherry.
It was. It was a good throw, I thought. Cherry had an opportunity to catch it. It looked like the defensive back had his hands all over Cherry there for a little bit early on. But Cherry had it in his hands and would have been a good one to pull in.
Instead, it's fourth down. Nick Pritchard having a good game will be out to punt the football after Delaware picks up a couple of first downs. Things stall at the middle of the field, as seemingly every drive has done for William & Mary and Delaware in this game. Pritchard kicks this one. It'll bounce it to six and cannot get to it, as they were trying to down the football. Tenny Adewusi has played so well on special teams, had it in front of him, and it's just ricocheted to the left of Adewusi. He couldn't get to it, and that'll send us to our first timeout. 11:39 remaining in quarter number three. Delaware up 10-0. That's your PNC Bank timeout score.
Klondike.
The official bird of Delaware isn't red. It's not green or purple. It's blue. Coincidence? We think not. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield Delaware. This blue hen does not need to see a podiatrist. But if he did, waiting for a referral might get his feathers in a bunch. And he wouldn't like that one bit. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield Delaware.
Hi guys, it's great to be here.
In the desert.
At the mall.
On the mountain.
At school.
At the beach.
In the Big Easy.
Yeah.
Today I want to show you guys the next gen Chevy Equinox. What do you think?
That's pretty.
Pretty sexy.
It's all wheel drive, look at that.
It looks aggressive.
But not overbearing. It's not too big, not too small.
Looks like it could go off-roading.
But at the same time, it looks like a car you could take to a nice event.
You can dress it up or dress it down.
Seems like the perfect car for anybody.
I would take it anywhere.
I want one.
I love it.
She's a bad mamma jamma.
Chevy stepped their game up.
Defenses, and we'll see Malcolm Brown back out there for our defense as Albert Funderburk is the running back behind Sean Mitchell to start the first drive of the second half for the William & Mary Tribe. Down 10-0, 11:39 left in the third, and we see a stoppage. And now they'll blow the whistle and start this one. Play clock starting to tick for Sean Mitchell. First time on the field as a collegiate athlete. And he'll be out of shotgun in the pistol. Funderburk behind him. Awaiting the snap is the freshman. And he gives the redshirt sophomore. Bouncing to the left side. Met by Ray Jones at the 23-yard line. But getting a healthy chunk on first down is Albert Funderburk.
Yeah, had pretty good penetration there, actually, defensive line. Kid made a good hop step and was able to pick up a few yards.
They're high on Funderburk. Made his season debut last week against Elon. Again, coming off of an ACL injury that took away most of his redshirt freshman season. Missed the final seven games last year and the first four this year. Now second down and six from the Tribe 24-yard line. And Sean Mitchell sends a man in motion. Jack Armstrong switching spots and rolling to the right is Mitchell. Looking to throw on the run. Batted by Troy Reeder and nearly intercepted by Ray Jones. Jones head down. No, he had a shot at that one. Lots of batted balls today, Ed.
Lots of batted balls. Big opportunities out there. Great coverage there by a cornerback. Made the quarterback look to the second level and got a finger on the ball.
Yeah, Mitchell had Reeder in pursuit, made a decision to throw it. Reeder got his hand on it. His brother Colby already has an INT, and that pass breakup makes it third down and six for William & Mary. And they've got it at their own 24-yard line, down by 10. Sean Mitchell with two wide receivers to the right side. tosses one to Armstrong, catches it at the 31, moves upfield to the 37-yard line, and that's a first down pickup for Jack Armstrong, his second catch of the day, and he got around freshman Nigel Hill.
Yeah, he ran a nice route there, did a good job, ball was on time, and got tripped up there, almost really popped the big one there.
Seeing the quarterback, Sean Mitchell, getting some tosses. That was probably the best toss that he's had today. His other throws has been screen passes or batted footballs, and a good timing route that time. Armstrong picks up the first down. First and 10 for William & Mary. At their own 36 now. Two wide receivers to the far side left. Play action. Mitchell. Pressure coming from Nichols, who slams the quarterback. And if pass falls incomplete around midfield. What a pursuit by Big Bilal.
Boy, I'll tell you what. I don't know if he was thinking to go deep there, but wide receiver had a really good release, and I thought he had our guy beat by a couple steps down the field, and I thought he was going to go deep, but he decided to go to the underneath guy.
Yeah, 6'4", 290 coming at you will make you change your mind pretty quickly, huh?
Yeah.
Sean Mitchell.
It would make me change my mind, for sure.
That big 92 coming at him. And now on second and 10, Nate Evans comes in for the first time this half. The freshman runner, as Mitchell goes under center. They've been rotating under center in shotgun form. Evans gets the carry. Has a hole on the right side. It closes quickly thanks to Troy Reeder, who's been all over the place to tackle that time at the 48-yard line, setting up third down.
Another great job by Troy Reeder, picking up right where he left off in the first half.
Reeder, those Reeder boys today have had quite the ball game.
Yes.
Troy leading the team in tackles. Colby an interception. Seven tackles for Troy Reeder now. And third down and seven. William & Mary just converted on third down. Play a go. The pass on the outside to Jack Armstrong. We'll try to do so again. 9:40, third quarter. Ends up 10-0. Evans is a running back standing next to Mitchell in shotgun form. Takes the snap. Throws. Passes deflected. Malcolm Brown. No injury there. He knocked it away, and we'll see the punt unit.
Way to close on the ball there. Great job. I mean, does this not look like a repeat of the first half already? William & Mary gets around midfield, and we stiffen up the defense and force a punt.
Doing a great job are the Hens in this one, that's for sure. Defense has looked solid throughout. They have yet to allow a point. Now we're looking at four-plus quarters since Delaware has allowed any points after shutting out Stony Brook in the second half up in New York. Fourth and seven. Will Michael on to punt. Jamie Jarman back to return. His feet at the 22, waving for it there. And Jamie Jarman won't get a return. But Delaware will start this drive. They'll actually mark it at the 23-yard line for Jamie Jarman. 9:21, a 33-yard punt for William Mary. That'll send us to another timeout. Your PNC Bank timeout score with 9:21 left in the third. Delaware 10, William Mary nothing.
Why choose Excel for your office equipment? Because it really is all about the more. More selection.
Into the post to Nick Harrison.
We've all been there.
Can't even see the score.
Oh my God.
Trying to watch the game on that tiny screen. It's time to watch sports the way they were meant to be watched. On this, in high definition, you can now watch all your favorite teams and players on the big screen for free. With CAA.TV, you'll never miss a moment. Take back the living room by searching CAA on your device.
The best part about playing in the CAA.
The best part about playing in the CAA is
by far the competition.
All the competition.
Each week, you never know what's going to happen.
We've had multiple teams win national championships.
James Madison, Kings of the FCS.
We got a lot of great players in this league who can make a play anytime.
When you have to prepare for the CAA teams each and every week, and that's what prepares you for playoffs. I think that's what makes it the most dominant conference.
Series.
your career. Spurs running back as we start this drive. J.P. Caruso has some time to throw. Coleman with his fifth catch of the season at the 42 and pushed out of bounds. Good way to start this drive with a first down pickup. Caruso to the freshman Coleman.
Another good first down call. Another big play on first down and a heck of a throw by Caruso. He had to throw a little. He had to put a little air under that ball to get over the defender and a perfect touch on that pass and a big play.
Coleman representing your number 19 very well, and we're going to see a lot from Gene Coleman in his career. He received offers from UConn and FBS school, Syracuse, Rutgers, Buffalo, and he chose Delaware. So this could be a primetime receiver playing in his first year. First and 10 for Delaware. They lead 10-0. Rolling out is Caruso, looking to throw again. Pressure coming. Down he goes. That's Gavin Johnson, the sophomore from Florida. Sacks the quarterback from Florida. Back at the 35.
Yeah, there's a covered sack there. Good job by William Mary secondary. Had our guys covered pretty well and nowhere to go.
After a 19-yard pickup on the first play of this drive, they'll move it backwards. A loss of 7. It's the first time J.P. Caruso has been sacked today. William Mary averages 4 sacks per game, fourth best in FCS football. So second down and long for the Hens. And they'll have 3 wide receivers. Jarman to the outside right. Out of shotgun is J.P. Caruso. Fires. It's high, jumping for Papali, but he couldn't haul it in. A little bit too high for the 6'1", 210 junior from Cherry Hill. And in coverage was Corey Parker, making sure he couldn't fully extend on his jump.
Yeah, he really unloaded on that one. Didn't hold back at all, and the ball floated just a hair on him.
So third down and 17, 8:02, third quarter. Ends up 10-0. They scored on a 27-yard touchdown toss from Caruso to Jamie Jarman. And then the last play of the first half was a Frank Rango 35-yard field goal. Second possession of this half. And Hens need 17 from their own 35 to move the sticks. Caruso, pressure coming, and he just gets it off. Throws it into the turf at the 40-yard line. Good pressure by the William & Mary defensive line, I believe. Isaiah Stevens got to him, and now we'll see the punt unit after a 4 and out.
Yeah, good pressure there. Looked like the idea was maybe to get a little dump off past and try to pick up a few yards, but the pressure was there, and he had nowhere to go with it.
Jalen Christian's had a busy day. Not many returns for Christian, but Nick Pritchard's been out there several times in this one. His 7th punt coming up, twice to start this third quarter, and William & Mary's getting closer and closer. There was some contact that time on
there
the punt.
Is.
Flag comes as Christian calls for a fair catch at the 31-yard line. All day long, it's been Noah Giles getting closer and closer to blocking one, and that time he got the leg of Nick Pritchard, so a flag.
Yeah, I agree. There was a couple close calls early on, and finally got there, and kicker did a good job of getting the ball off, and we got the call.
We'll hear the call from Kelvin Hudson.
Running into the kicker, defense. That's a 5-yard penalty. It'll be tacked on at the end of the run, first down.
So the difference there, not roughing the kicker, which would have given Delaware a first. That was close to roughing the kicker as Nick Pritchard took a shot.
Yeah, probably the right call, though. I don't know if it qualified for a roughing. Here's the replay right now.
We're looking at it here at Delaware Stadium. Looks like Giles, yeah, barely. Oh, that's Nick Pritchard. The Emmy Award goes to, I think. He fooled us up here. Nice acting job by Nick Pritchard. Maybe an Oscar for that one.
Yeah.
The movie star out of New Egypt, New Jersey. Transfer from Maryland. He has certainly at least been a rock star for this team, punting the ball very well this year in his first year in blue and gold. So now William & Mary with the football back. Finally up over 100 yards of total offense. 113 for William & Mary, and they'll start this drive. 7:51, third quarter. First and 10 at their own 31, and Nate Evans is the running back. Sean Mitchell in his first career game, 9 of 19 at the quarterback spot. Coming into the game, Tommy McKee, we thought might be the starter. If not him, we were ready to see Brandon Battle, who took over last game against Elon. And then close to kickoff, we found out it would be Sean Mitchell, who we have no notes on, no information. He was recruited out of Oscar Smith High School and obviously a talent starting as a true freshman. And the officials don't know what's going on right now. They've re-spotted this ball twice, and now they're having another conversation.
Well, I'll tell you what, you know, on that note, it's a surprise to us to see who was starting quarterback today. But, you know, the defense had no no idea who was playing, so there was no preparation for this guy. Give our defense a lot of credit for not being able to have any film on this quarterback, and we're doing a really good job containing him so far.
That's a great point you make, Eddie, because this is the third time out of now six games, half the games, Delaware has gone on to the season.
It's under question. That play is under review.
We're going to hear that they're going to review the play. Just finishing the point, this is the third time in six games that Delaware has faced a team not knowing who the quarterback is going to be. Against Delaware State, you have no film on the quarterback because they just weren't releasing who the quarterback was going to be. We thought it was going to be one guy, and it ends up being another. Against Cornell, it was their first game of the year, so you have no film on their quarterback. And now you go into William Mayer. I remember talking earlier in the week with Coach Rocco, and we're discussing, hey, Tommy McKee, Brandon Battle, what are the differences? And he gave credit to Jimmy Laycock, as he always does, about, you know, no matter who the quarterback is, they run a solid system at William Mary. But neither of us thought that Sean Mitchell would be the starting quarterback today. And as a freshman, not making much happen, but not a whole lot of big errors. That last play of the first half, certainly a big one with the interception. But I got to put that on the play calling of William & Mary, to not take a knee or not run the football into the locker room. You weren't using your timeouts. Why throw the football? Why take a chance? And it ends up three extra points for Delaware.
Yeah, I couldn't agree with you anymore. The quarterback hasn't really done anything to hurt them. I agree. That was a little bit of a shocking play call there to throw a ball in the middle of the field like that.
So we are having a play that's under review here. So I think maybe the spot of the football. They're reviewing the spot of the football. How can you get wrong a fair catch spot of the football? I mean, that's on the referees. You're out there paying attention to the game. I don't understand how that can be under review and how you can take this much time to review the spot of the football.
There's always at some point in the game where you kind of scratch your head of what the heck's going on, right?
We're seeing officials walk over to William Mary's sideline, run over to Danny Rocco to give explanations. A lot of officials going all over the place. Cue up the tape, see where he caught the football, subtract five, and let's get this thing rolling. 7:51, third quarter. Great crowd here today, Eddie, by the way.
Hey, great crowd. I mentioned it earlier. It's really good to see. You know, the corners of the stands are starting to fill up, top right and top left corner on the visitor's side. That's a good sign.
I think everybody's excited about Coach Rocco. Everybody's excited about the win against Stony Brook. And
well, winning heals everything.
Absolutely.
There's no doubt about that. Winning heals everything. Keep winning and they will come. That's the old thing.
We will eventually get a spot of this football. I've never seen anything quite like this, to spot the football. Finally, we'll hear from Kelvin Hudson, the referee.
After review, the ball will be placed at the 31-yard line. The penalty was declined. First down.
All right.
Yeah. You got to get some booze for that. That was a waste of everyone's time. He caught the football at the 31. If the penalty was declined, that's where they get the football, and that's what we're seeing. First and 10.
Not rocket science.
Yeah, it certainly isn't. We've got Albert Funderburk in for William & Mary, and not a whole lot going on for these runners. That one of the bigger gains, and it's 6.5, maybe 7 yards. Ray Jones comes in on the tackle. Hard run by Funderburk. That's a solid first down pickup.
Another.
It'll set up second down about 4 at the William Mary 37-yard line. I can't remember last time William Mary was on Delaware's side of the field. This is as close as they've been in quite some time. Second and 4 at their own 37. Sean Mitchell's the quarterback. 7:20 and ticking. He sends a man in motion. And he'll throw near the Delaware sideline. Pass is caught. Armstrong slips one. Colby Reeder shoves him out of bounds at the 46-yard line. It's a first down pickup. Second first down catch of the day for Jack Armstrong, the junior from Morgantown, West Virginia.
Had a nice blitz there on coming from the right side of Delaware. Almost got to the quarterback, but he did a good job of releasing it. The receiver did a good job making a catch again on field.
I think we're starting to see Sean Mitchell seem a little bit more comfortable in the pocket. A couple of nice throws to Jack Armstrong in the second half. Trips to the left side. Runner is Funderburk. Screen pass. Going to go for almost nothing as Christian gets past Anthony Jackson at first, but Ray Jones helps out at the 42. Could have been a loss back to the 39. He got out of the hands of Jackson, but good pursuit by Buck, and still a loss of big yardage.
Yeah, a loss is a loss. We'd have liked to see him, just like to have him make a shorthand tackle there. But good effort by the guy breaking the tackle, and another Delaware guy right there to make that tackle.
Yeah,
right
about the pursuit of Anthony Jackson coming over from the left side of the field. Second down and 14. for William & Mary back at their own 42 after the tackle for loss by Buck Jones. They'll give it to the running back. It's Funderburk trying to move the pile and doing so. Strong run still going at the 50. Midfield, Delaware's 49. How about that run after contact? Armin Ware, Troy Reeder, both in on the stop, but there was just a pile that kept moving into Delaware territory.
I think they got another 4.5 yards with the pile just moving like that. That was pretty big.
That goes from second and 14 to third down and 5 from the Delaware 49-yard line. The
Much
Tribe, 3 of 9 on third down. Runner is Evans, two wide receivers to the right. Sean Mitchell's the quarterback, down 10-0. 5:45, third quarter. Big third down here. Mitchell pumps. Now he's scrambling, looking, and Jackson makes the tackle back at the 41-yard line. Armin Ware there as well. Big stop by the defense.
Woo! Big, big, big. Great job by these guys. Gave him a little bit too much time, I thought. But again, a covered sack.
That's coverage that time, as you're absolutely right. The quarterback, Mitchell, had some time to look downfield, and he just had no one to throw the football to. And you give this defense enough time, they're going to get to you.
Eddie back.
Great job by Anthony Jackson, who almost had a tackle for a loss a couple plays earlier, gets a sack that time around. Punt unit on for William & Mary, no pressure. Jamie Jarman running for it, waves his arms at the 24 about, so no return. And Delaware's offense back on the field. When we come back, 4:55 remaining in the third quarter, your PNC Bank timeout score, Delaware 10, Tribe nothing.
Picture this, it's Monday afternoon. How do you show up? Do you just bring it? Or do you bring it all?
Focus.
Third row, like a pro. Step up to GMC and get $4,000 purchase allowance on almost every 2017 GMC Acadia model when you finance through GM Financial. We are professional grade GMC.
Whether you're a morning person, or simply, it's not your thing. Maybe you're the type that doesn't take it that seriously. Or you're that person who just makes everyone's morning brighter. There's a McDonald's for every morning.
Enjoy a sausage burrito for $1 or a sausage McGriddle sandwich for $2. Pair it with any size freshly brewed McCafe hot coffee for $1.
Rocco comes out onto the field. They'll start this drive at their own 24-yard line, first and 10. And Pete Caruso, the quarterback, 8 of 19, 80 yards. Similar stat line last week against Stony Brook. Time to add to it, though, as we've got 20 more minutes left of football today. Caruso bobbles the snap, gets it, and tosses one wide to a diving wide receiver on the far side of the field. I believe that was Deontay Cherry, who couldn't haul in his second what would have been a diving catch of the day.
Yeah, it looks like the bobble made him throw off the timing just a little bit.
Here we go, some substitutions. Williams to the sideline, as is Whaley and Cherry, and we'll see Jarman come in, Papali, and Joe Walker will be in the game. Every time Joe Walker's been in the game, they split out J.P. Caruso. They'll do so to the far side of the field this time. Kane is the running back next to Joe Walker, who stands in shotgun form on second down and 10. Walker on the QB draw play. Up the middle he goes. He's hit by Parker. Stands on his feet at the 30, down at the 31-yard line. That was a nice crack by Parker, but Walker didn't fall. It took a second Tribe tackler to bring him down. And Joe Walker on these quarterback designed runs has looked pretty solid today.
Yeah, he sure has. I'm wondering what they're going to be able to do moving forward with this, with that idea. You know, maybe start, split out Caruso and instead of having Walker run the ball, maybe he can throw one eventually. And you know, there's a lot of things that could build off of this formation. It's going to be exciting moving forward.
Walker's a second leading rusher today. 4 carries, 24 yards for him. And now empty backfield, 5 wide receivers for J.P. Caruso on 3rd down and 3 from his own 31. Caruso tosses one, sideline for Coleman, and it falls out of bounds. Caught by Chichi Amachi, but he was on the side out in the game. So incomplete pass by Caruso. That one didn't really have a chance for the intended receiver.
No, it did. It looked like it was another good coverage play there by the defense. Nowhere really to go with the ball. Threw it out of bounds, looked like more than anything else.
3rd down and 3, I thought perhaps we were going to see with empty backfield maybe a design run for Caruso, who's converted some 3rd downs with his feet, but not that time around. 4 minutes left in the 3rd, and Hens will punt it again. 8 punt of the day for Nick Pritchard. Delaware now just 2 of 13 on 3rd downs today. Not a good stat. Pressure again, and Pritchard not phased. Gets off a good one.
Wow.
They're going to mark the fair catch at the 20-yard line. Wow, Nick Pritchard unfazed, a 49-yard punt. He's got Noah Giles to the right of him, about an inch away from block punt every time he's kicked the football, and he's been booming them all day long.
He's unflappable, man. That was really, really a great punt there.
Good pickup in the offseason, a transfer from Maryland. Nick Pritchard, as Delaware went to transfer out last year, bringing in a punter from NC State. He graduated, and Pritchard's done a solid job. So William & Mary not being able to do much offensively. 124 total yards of offense, 69 on the ground, 55 through the air. Back on the field, 1st and 10, 3:51, 3rd quarter. Down 10 to nothing. Kuzjak in motion. Jackson blitzing, and he gets to the runner. He came all the way from the near side of the field to the far side to track down Albert Funderburk to stop him for a gain of just 1.
That's a hustle play there. Great job by number 11. Excellent job scraping from the backside.
Jackson, part of this linebacking core that's so good. Coming into the year, the two readers, Bell and Jackson, and now with Bell out for the year, Jalen Kindle's having a solid season as well. His 3rd game replacing Charles Bell, or 2nd and a half. And Kindle on the year, 26 tackles. 2nd down and 9. They'll send a man in motion. The tight end retraces to the right side. At the 21-yard line, Mitchell waits for the snap, gets it. QB option. He's going to throw down the middle of the field. Double team, and Adderley picks it off at the 30. Running at the 40. Cuts it at midfield. Looking for blockers at the 45. Spins off a tackler at the 40. Another tackler at the 30. Finally dragged down at the 26-yard line. Nasir Adderley's 2nd INT of the year.
Hey, here we go. That'll wake a crowd up there. What a great play by them. I thought the quarterback made a bad decision throwing that ball into the middle of the field. There was 2 defenders there. And, you know, in a play like that, you never know if it's going to be batted down or caught. And our guy did a great job of going up, high pointing the ball, and making a play, and then doing a great job becoming a wide receiver after he caught it and making a big play.
Adderley, when he's made interceptions, he's had big returns. That one for 44 yards. And it sets up Delaware with great field position, 5 yards away from the red zone. They're at the 25-yard line. Runner is Kareem Williams. To the right of J.P. Caruso, and shotgun is Kyle Yoakum. Williams gets the give. Outside right. Hesitation, stiff arm to the 25. Breaks down to the 20, and down he goes after an 8-yard pickup to the 17.
Great run there by him. Great run. Nice little jab step to the inside. Froze the defensive guy for just a second and did a good job getting back out to the outside. Great run.
Again, an interception giving Delaware a chance to score. They picked up 3 after Colby got one to end the first half. We'll see what they can do after Nas sends it to the 25. The 18-yard line is the spot of the football. And this one's going to be blown dead. False start, Delaware. So they'll go backwards, hurting themselves.
False start. Offense, number 54. 5-yard penalty. Remains 2nd down.
Remember, at the end of that 2nd quarter, Delaware had the football at the 18-yard line. 1st and 10, and there was a holding penalty that sent Delaware backwards 10 yards. This time, False start moves them back five. So second down and eight. Delaware hurting themselves in the red zone.
I mentioned it earlier. The SIWs, those self-inflicted wounds, they are costly. And Delaware's had too many of them. They have to limit that. And we got to stop doing that. It's a big possession here.
Brody Kern, the senior captain, called for the false start. Split out. Far side of left is Cherry and Jarman. And there was some movement. It looked like Jarman was still moving. Yeah, that one looks like it's going to go against Delaware again. We'll wait for the call.
False start. Offense, number 80. That's a five-yard penalty. It remains second down.
Cherry with his hands to the sky saying, that wasn't me. I think it was Jarman in motion. But either way, they were together on that far left side of the field. And now instead of what would have been second down and three, you've got two false starts, and you're looking at second down and 13 outside of the red zone at 28. This drive started at the 25, so you're minus three thanks to two penalties. Green Williams is the running back next to J.P. Caruso, the QB, on second down and 13. A minute 30 remaining, and the give is to Green Williams, crisscrossing to the right side. He gets back to the original line of scrimmage at 25. Pickup of three, gang tackled there, and Delaware's going to have third down and long.
Yeah, so, you know, here we are, third down and long. We're, you know, we're looking at a pretty good situation a little bit earlier. So two penalties, very costly.
They had to settle for a field goal after penalties in the first half, and we'll see if that's the case again. Now under a minute, third quarter, up 10 to nothing are the Blue Hens, and the runner next to J.P. Caruso is Kenai Kane. Split out to the right is Jarman. Pocket closing on Caruso. He gets rid of it. And the pass was too wide for Papali. A corner route. And he just couldn't get to it. Could Vinny. And a man is down for Delaware. Jethro Pepe, I believe, is down at the 34-yard line.
That was actually a pretty good route by Papali. Did a good job getting upfield. Made a little jab step to the middle and then broke out. And ball was just a little bit out of reach.
Delaware's already had depth issues on the offensive line this season. If Jethro Pepe can't get up, that's going to be more of a problem. As we move Mario Farinella to the defensive side of the football, he was the backup right guard. Steve Robinson missed the first couple of games. Now he's in at the guard position. Noah Bay from Penn State's been mixing in and out. We've got two seniors, Trump at left tackle, Brody Kern at the center position, and Jethro is a junior. Placing Connor Bozick at that right tackle spot, and it's not looking good right now for Jethro Pepe. This is a Newark urgent care injury stoppage as he's getting looked at. It'll be fourth down and 10 for Delaware at the 25-yard line. It's where this drive started. They got an 8-yard pickup by Kareem Williams, and then a couple penalties sent him backwards, and we're going to test the leg of Frank Rago once again.
Yeah, yep, big opportunity there, missed. 3 points will definitely be helpful, but boy, I tell you, 7 points would have maybe put this thing out of reach.
Yeah, you really felt that if Delaware, after the interception by Nasir Adderley, a 45-yard return to the 25-yard line, if they could have punched that in, you really would have felt good about things going into the fourth quarter. Still feel good if you can get a field goal here, but
yeah,
it would have been tough for William Mary the way they've played offensively, you feel, to get two touchdowns and a field goal in 15 minutes of action. 15
yeah, well,
plus minutes.
I mean, that's what penalties can do. Can yep. really take the wind out of your sails. You know, we were really excited there, and boom, boom, and now here we go. So let's get this kick and move on.
So it's going to be a 42-yard try for Frank Rago. He's made from 35 today, made from 50 a week ago. Hold is down, kick is up, and Rago, no good that time. I believe wide and perhaps short to the left. So after starting a drive on the 25-yard line, 5 yards away from the red zone, William & Mary gets a defensive stop, and the Hens D will be back on the field.
Well, not good. You know, not good. We got to test our grit here. Defense has got to step back up again and limit these guys, not let them get past midfield. And that was a great opportunity missed.
Wide to the left, they call it. Delaware, that drive taking just 35 seconds off of the clock. They went backwards after penalties, got back to the original line of scrimmage, and then a missed 42-yard try by Frank Rago. Offense back on the field for William & Mary. Evans is a running back, first and 10 from their own 25. Mitchell wants to throw, does so. Pass is caught by Christian, a 9-yard pickup, maybe 10, depending on the spot, to the 34-yard line.
Good pickup there. Zone coverage. Wide receiver did a great job of settling and then sliding into the window. Quarterback did a nice job finding him and threw a strike.
Mitchell's looking more comfortable here in the second half. This true freshman playing his first game. Tommy Wilmot with the tackle there, the redshirt senior from Salesiana, a grad student, biology major, got his degree in the spring. 4 seconds to go in the third quarter, and William Mary doesn't get it off. That'll send it to the fourth quarter of football. Delaware leads 10-0, 15 minutes left from Delaware Stadium over William & Mary. That's your PNC Bank timeout score.
Stop.
Hi, guys. It's great to be here.
In the desert.
At the mall.
On the mountain.
At school.
At the beach.
In the Big Easy.
Yeah.
Today, I want to show you guys the next-gen Chevy Equinox. What do you think?
That's pretty.
Pretty sexy.
It's all-wheel drive. Look at that.
It looks aggressive.
But not overbearing.
It's not too big, not too small.
Looks like it could go off-roading.
But at the same time, it looks like a car you could take to a nice event.
You can dress it up or dress it down.
Seems like the perfect car for anybody.
I would take it anywhere.
I want one.
I love it.
She's a bad mamma jamma.
Chevy stepped their game up.
The official bird of Delaware isn't red. It's not green or purple. It's blue. Coincidence? We think not. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield Delaware. This blue hen does not need to see a podiatrist. But if he did, waiting for a referral might get his feathers in a bunch. And he wouldn't like that one bit. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield Delaware.
Whether you're a morning person or simply it's not your thing. Maybe you're the type that doesn't take it that seriously. Or you're that person who just makes everyone's morning brighter. There's a McDonald's for every morning.
Enjoy a sausage burrito for $1 or a sausage McGriddle sandwich for $2. Pair it with any size freshly brewed McCafe hot coffee for $1.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart, moving forward.
He already has his left ankle taped up, so we'll see what happens. Thank you, Corey. Pepe's been battling some injuries his career. Options on the offensive line at the tackle position. Carter Lynch a possibility. James Kretkowski perhaps can come in. We'll keep an eye out on the offensive line and see what's going on as we head to the fourth quarter of football. Delaware up 10-0, 15 minutes left, and second down and one coming up for William & Mary after a 9-yard gain on first down for the Tribe. They'll switch sides of the field. William & Mary going right to left as we see it up in the Delaware press box. Kuzjak in motion. Evans the back. They go to the freshman. Big hole up the middle. Burst of speed gets him a first down to the 41-yard line before contact was made. And that's a solid back-to-back runs. Colby Reeder made the stop. And William Mary starting to put together something.
It's a nice run. We haven't seen that for a little while now. Early on, I thought he looked really quick and hit the hole hard. It was reminiscent of the first quarter there.
Yeah, Nate Evans, the freshman, leads the team in rushing on the season. 55 attempts, 268 yards coming in, three touchdowns. He scored in each of the last three games, but no one scored for the Tribe in this one. Down 10-0, just underway, fourth quarter. And it's first and 10 at the Tribe 42-yard line. Mitchell has some time in the pocket. No one's open. He rolls out towards the sideline, sprinting as he tucks at the 45. Out of bounds he goes. A pickup of maybe four. But again, solid coverage by Delaware in the secondary. It was John Nassib who finally tracked down Mitchell and pushed him out.
Yeah, solid coverage. Good job. Forced him to run. Quarterback showed he's got some wheels. You know, it was a good play by him.
Mitchell, true freshman. Third string quarterback getting the start today, though. Tommy McKee. Threw for 558 yards this season, five touchdowns, four INTs. The backup, Brennan Battle, threw for a touchdown last week against Elon. And Jimmy Laycock making the switch. Second down and five at the 47 of William & Mary. And Sean Mitchell out of shotgun form. Fakes a give to the running back. Swing pass is dropped by Jalen Christian. It was just ahead of him. It looked like Christian took his eye off the football just momentarily, and it was enough to let it fall out of his hands.
Yeah, it looks like the ball got away from the young quarterback there, floated on him just a little bit.
It was a forward pass, very clearly. A couple weeks ago, there was a backwards pass or that was hard to tell that cost Delaware some points against James Madison. That one on the swing, clearly ahead of where Sean Mitchell tossed it. And now we got third down and five. Redshirt freshman Sal Morrow in on the defensive line for Delaware. Hens showing some pressure with Kendall. Also Troy Reeder. They back off. Mitchell takes the snap. The toss is made. Catch is made at the 49. It'll depend where they stick it. Tyler Klaus, the tight end, was tackled as soon as he grabbed it. And
short, maybe.
Early indication looks like it might be a little bit short. They should measure.
Wow. Close.
Crowd here not liking the spot. And they are. They're not even going to measure. They're going to give him a first down.
Looked close enough for a measurement to me.
Yeah, I thought maybe they should take a look at that. Nice wrap-up by Delaware, not allow any extra yards. I thought they might have stuffed them. Good job by the tight end Klaus, though, knowing exactly where he had to get to, parking himself there and allowing the quarterback to find the big target. 13-24, and now a whistle. Maybe we're seeing a review.
Rocco wasn't happy about that.
Play clock was not run.
Oh, okay. We've had a lot of
please start
of
the
trouble.
Game clock and the play clock on my signal.
Is that self-inflicted wounds by the officiating staff today?
It's going all. It's contagious.
It is contagious here today at Delaware Stadium. First and 10, though. And William Mary in Delaware territory. It's been rare since they've gotten the football in Hens territory today. They've not been close to scoring. No trips to the red zone. Mitchell pumps. Going to go the opposite side of the field. The Kuzjak way overthrows him. Kuzjak was at the 25. Ball landed about the 13-yard line, and that was Nigel Hill in coverage. Redshirt freshman from Baltimore has played solid in his first year.
Yeah, it looked like a throwaway there to me. It looked like what they were trying to do was get the guy tight end, the slot guy on the right side, to do a little stop and go, but he did the stop and never did the go. And the quarterback looked the other side and just threw it away.
Yeah, Chris Conlin was running a wheel route, and Sean Mitchell just pumped and then looked the other direction. Mitchell 12 of 24 now for 64 yards. Second down and 10 at the Delaware 48-yard line. Two wide receivers near side left. Runner is Evans. He'll get the give to the left side. He runs right into Blaine Woodson. Help from Jackson at the 44. And it's going to be third down for William & Mary.
I mean, have we seen this before? Third down at midfield?
Yeah, it seems like all day. That's where William & Mary has been. And neither team has fared well on third down. William & Mary a little bit better than Delaware. They're 4 of 11 on third down today. This will be big for Delaware. Crowd into it. 12-27, fourth quarter. And it's third down and 6 for the Tribe. Three down linemen for Delaware. Showing some pressure. Mitchell tosses to an open tight end. Pass is caught at the 36-yard line. And down he goes at the 35. First down pickup for Klaus.
That was a good little play call there. Number 82 going the one way and number 2 coming back the other direction. And quarterback did a good job being patient and finding a guy open in the middle.
Klaus's second first down pickup on this drive. 9 yards that time. He had a 5-yard pickup on third down and 5 earlier in the drive. So it continues in the Tribe working the ball down the field. 8 plays, 40 yards so far on this drive. Single back is Albert Funderburk, the redshirt sophomore. First and 10 at the Hens 35. Funderburk, the give, looking for room. He slipped as he crossed the 35 and down to the 33. He goes. Malcolm Brown in the area on the tackle.
Well, I hate to go back to those two penalties earlier, but here we go. You know, we had an opportunity to make it a 17-0 game. We failed to do that, miss a field goal. It's 10-0. Now here's William & Mary with the furthest penetration of the game and in position to maybe get some points on the board, and now we got a game.
That's a great point. Delaware had the football first and 10 from the 25 and then second and 3 from the 18. Two penalties sent him backwards and a missed field goal later. Here comes William & Mary, second down and 8. Ball in the 33 of Delaware. Mitchell, he's been in rhythm on this drive. Throws and deflected by Troy Reeder. Solid coverage on Daniel Kuzjak at around that first down marker.
Good coverage there. Good job by Reeder again.
Reeder's having a solid game. You can say that pretty much every time out on the football field for Troy Reeder. Junior, captain of this team. Leads the team with tackles coming in. Transfer from Penn State. We got Casey Hinton coming into the game here on third down and eight. 11:05 fourth quarter. Here we go, big play. William Mary has converted two third downs on this drive, both to Tyler Klaus. They need eight from the Hens 33. Pressure coming. It's Reeder again with the sack.
Look who it is. Would you look at this guy? I love Reeder. Man, he is fun to watch. What an exciting guy, and what a great play by him.
Another tackle for loss for Troy Reeder. He just flies, Eddie. He flies in there and gets the quarterback.
He does. There's zero fear in this guy. He's 110 miles per hour every play. And, you know, you feed off of something like that if you're a resident defense. Here we go.
Fourth down and 11. William Mary going to stay on the field. They are 5 of 6 on the season on fourth down. Sixth best in FCS, first in the CAA. Reeder calling for some noise. They need 11 from the Delaware 36-yard line. Mitchell takes the snap. Pressure coming from Woodson. Mitchell throws, blocked away. Nasir Adderley with the pass breakup, and Delaware's offense comes back on the field.
Man, what a great play again. Same reminiscent of earlier. Guy was open for a second, and our guy gets in front, knocks the ball down. I'll tell you, Mike Williams, Pops must be really licking his chops here. Excited about watching this defense. They're doing a great job.
What a job by Nasir Adderley. He had the interception on the last drive and a diving pass breakup across the body of Isaiah Kinder. Ends that drive on fourth and 11. What a play by Nasir Adderley. He's having a heck of a day. He's had a heck of a career already. The junior from Philadelphia, his cousin Herb Adderley, a three-time Super Bowl champ, a Hall of Famer in the class of 1980. And Knox. Looking like Cousin Herb again today. 10:15 left to play. And Delaware up 10-0. Offense back under center, J.P. Caruso. Kane is the runner. Shifts his way to the 38. Pickup of two.
Well, not much excitement on the offensive side, but we, you know, the crowd has been gotten off their butts a little bit because of the defense making big plays.
It's rare, Eddie, that the defense can excite a crowd the way that this Delaware defense has really throughout this season. I mean, they have been so good, exciting plays like the interception. Fans love Reeder with good reason. Colby with an interception as well. And now we see Joe Walker in at quarterback. Split to the right. Near side is J.P. Caruso. QB option they give to Jefferson. Stiff arm brings him to the 40-yard line. And he drives his way forward. Good effort by Jefferson to the 41. But it'll be a third down and 5 coming up for Delaware. Running the football, running the clock, making it difficult for William & Mary to get back and be able to score twice. This two-possession game ends up 10-0.
I keep waiting for them to have Walker pull that ball out and look downfield and find somebody wide open. Let's look for that moving forward.
We see some good news on the field as Jethro Pepe is back in the game at that right tackle position. He had come out earlier, and that's a good sign for the Delaware offense. Third down and 5 for the Hens. They've been miserable on third down today. 1 of 13. Caruso grabbed by Gavin Johnson. That's his second sack of the day for Gavin Johnson. Big number 99 came in and brought down the quarterback who was looking to run with it. They needed a 5. They got maybe back to line of scrimmage and a quick drive that time by the Hens.
Yeah, I thought that was another instance of Caruso maybe being a little bit too quick on his decision. That definitely was not a design run. He had the guy wide open here on the left, on the right side, and he decided to run it too quickly, I thought.
So Delaware quickly gives the football back to William & Mary. We see Pritchard has been having a busy day out there. Yeah. Jalen Christian, he's been busy as well, back to return. Pressure again, and almost blocked again. But a beautiful spiraling kick by Pritchard. Blocked by Christian. Delaware picked it up.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Christian dropped the football.
Oh, yeah.
Delaware picked it up. And that's Nasir Adderley again. Have a day.
Oh, that's just beautiful. I got to tell you, I didn't mention it. I didn't say it, but I've been thinking it all game here. With these punts, the way this punter's been booming the ball, there's an opportunity for a guy to misread the catch. And it finally happened, and our guy was right there to make the big play.
Delaware will start with the football inside the red zone. Another turnover. It'll be first and 10 at the 14 with 8:03 remaining when we come back. Here, PNC Bank, timeout score. Delaware 10, William Mary nothing.
as Delaware's first and only 24/7 urgent care.
How do you show up? Do you just bring it? Or do you bring it all?
Focus.
Third Row, like a pro. Step up to GMC and get $4,000 purchase allowance on almost every 2017 GMC Acadia model when you finance through GM Financial. We are professional grade. GM.
Once into the post to Nick Harrison.
We've all been there.
I can't even see the score.
Oh my God.
Trying to watch the game on that tiny screen. It's time to watch sports the way they were meant to be watched. On this, in high definition. You can now watch all your favorite teams and players on the big screen for free. With CAA.TV, you'll never miss a moment. Take back the living room by searching CAA on your device.
The best part about playing in the CAA...
The best part about playing in the CAA is by far the competition.
All the competition.
Each week, you never know what's going to happen.
Multiple teams won national championships.
James Madison, Kings of the FCS.
We got a lot of great players in this league who can make a play anytime.
When you have to prepare for the CAA teams each and every week, that's what prepares you for playoffs. I think that's what makes it the most dominant conference.
In motion goes Jamie Jarman. He'll fake the sweep to him. Kane has some room up the middle, barreling over defenders and down at the 5-yard line, a pickup of 9 on first down.
Great job there bringing the guy in motion and not handing it to him, handing it to the guy in the back. And he made an excellent jump cut and showed some acceleration and got upfield. Good job.
A touchdown here, you got to feel. We'll put this one away for Delaware. The way William Mary has been unsuccessful moving the football. Just 146 yards of total offense for the Tribe, only 152 for Delaware. But a score here, you're feeling good with 7:26 to go. Second down and one from the 5. Caruso under center. In motion goes Whaley. Kane hesitates, pushes down at the 3. First down, though, it'll be goal to go from about 3.5.
Boy, I'll tell you, Kane's a load, man. He's a big guy. He pushes the pile.
Kenai Kane, that short yardage back. That was his role originally on the season, but they found out, hey, this guy could get some more snaps throughout the game. 6 feet tall, 740 pounds, was an all-state selection at Sussex Tech High School here in Delaware.
Did you say 740 pounds? He's bigger
240
than, bigger
pounds.
Than I thought.
Did I say 700? My goodness, that's the offensive line. He's got 700 pounds in front of him, yeah. Trying to push these defenders backwards. First and goal to go from the 3. Offset eye. Yoakum is the fullback. Kane is the running back. Caruso under center. It's Kenai Kane lowering his head and trying to dig for that goal line about a yard short.
Good try there. Another good run. Like to see him lower his head like that and go for the line. That was great.
But here you go. You don't score the touchdown, but you keep the clock turning at 6:20.
Yes.
It'll
yes.
be second and goal to go from almost the 2-yard line.
No hurry here at all. I want to see that play clock down to 1 before that ball gets snapped.
Kane again stands behind J.P. Caruso. Ball on the far half. Caruso under center. Kern will snap it to the junior quarterback. Kenai Kane stopped on his first try, second effort, into the end zone. Kenai Kane makes it 16-0.
Woo! Nice job. Great job. Great second effort. Big, big, big touchdown right there. That was huge. All started with a great turnover and patience by the running back. Second effort, and here we go. Opportunity to go up 17 with 5 minutes to go.
Fifth rushing touchdown of the season for Kenai Kane. The transfer from Lackawanna Community College, getting an opportunity with the University of Delaware and taking advantage this season. 16-0 Delaware on top, 5:52 to go. And Frank Rago on for the extra point try. Pritchard will hold, low snap. Pritchard spins it, and Rago gets it through. 17-0. Your PNC Bank timeout score with 5:52 left to play from Delaware Stadium.
With days getting busier and the holidays around the corner, now's your chance.
That we knew was likely to prevail in this game, and they have both teams around the 150 total yard mark, but it's just been, you know, who can take advantage of missed cues by the other team, and it's been Delaware scoring a field goal after an interception and scoring a touchdown just there after a muffed punt by Jalen Christian. Still see some smoke on the field after the Delaware touchdown. There was a blue and yellow smoke shot into the student section. Now a fog Jake Roth kicks into. Out of the end zone, Christian takes it out. 15-yard line, now 20. Contact there. Down it goes at the 21-yard line. I think Christian was trying to earn some points back and take one on a return that time after fumbling the football last time out on the punt return. So William Mary down to 5:46 to try to get something. And the Delaware defense now working on almost six quarters without allowing a point. They shut out Stony Brook in the second half and were 5:46 from a shutout today against the Trot.
Yeah, that's great. Stuff. That is impressive stuff.
Doing so in front of honorary captain Mike Adams, who's been on the sideline watching his hens proudly. One of the greatest defenders of all time to play at Delaware. I'm sure at one point he's going to join you in that UD Athletics Hall of Fame.
No
Mitchell
doubt about it.
On first down, going to scramble a bit, and he's tracked down by Tommy Wilmoth. How about Tommy Wilmoth? The great story, a redshirt senior. He was a teammate of Troy and Colby Reeder back at a Salesiano team that was phenomenal in the high school ranks here in Delaware, and getting some playing time and looking good out there.
Good to see. It really is good to see.
Hometown hen Tommy Wilmoth from Newark, Delaware. Second down and eight from Wilmington, Delaware, I should say. Second down and eight. For Mitchell, far side of the field, his toss is caught by Kuzjak, but he had to dive for it, so down he goes at the 28-yard line, a pickup of five. It'll be third down and three, clock ticking at 5:06.
You know, not too much going on offensively for William & Mary, but I think, you know, at the end of this, you're not going to be too upset with what you saw with your young freshman.
Yeah, Mitchell looked poised at times. He just ran into a really solid Delaware defense, I think. Mitchell, screen pass after he surveyed the field, dumped it down to Evans. Evans trying to run for first down yardage, but won't be able to, and we'll likely see William & Mary stay on the field here. Fourth down, and I think he lost a yard. Fourth down and four should be coming up. Now we're going to punt the football.
Yeah.
Giving it back to Delaware, and Jimmy Laycock saying, well done, Delaware. Well done. So the hands an opportunity to maybe pick up a couple of first downs, and if they can do so, they'll improve to 4-2 on the season and 2-1 in conference play. William & Mary, unfortunately for them, going to look like they're going to drop to 0-3 in the CAA. Jamie Jarman will be back to return once again. A lot of punts in this ball game. This one wobbling. Jarman going to wave for it.
Good job.
And you were saying off mic as we talked earlier in the day, punt returners, what do they got to do when they're out there looking to return the football?
Well, I mean, the one thing that my father was the one who taught me this a long time ago is, you know, run first and look second. You know, I've said that time and time again. You catch the ball, you get upfield as quickly as possible. You know, what a lot of return guys do is they look first and they run second. It's run first and look second. And it's all about getting
upfield. It seems dangerous, Eddie.
It is dangerous. I don't know. I guess I'm a little bit crazy, but I loved every second of it.
That's the way you played for sure, and it excited the fans. Hey, if the Hens can get 3 points on this drive, that means the Hens will have 20 points in the game. And when Delaware scores 20 points in the game, you score 20% off your dinner bill at Klondike Kate's on Sunday. That's right. Just show your ticket stub or share the final score post on social media, and you'll receive 20% off the amazing Klondike Kate's menu tomorrow for a dinner at Klondike Kate's on Main Street, Newark, the home of the UD Football Coaches Show. And we love the support of Klondike Cates. Join us for the Coaches Show. Eddie, you were on it on Wednesday, and great job by you as our special guest. And always talk to a player. Coach Rocco always has great things to say at the show. And come join us every Wednesday at Klondike Cates, 7 to 8 o'clock. If you can't make it, it's on 94.7 WDSD, and we always post the audio for download the next day. Yeah, but
that's a good show. That's a really good time, and you know, it's if you're a fan of Delaware football, I got to tell you, you get there, you want to hear Coach Rocco. He is something special. I'm really, really high on this guy. You know, very, very impressed every time I've heard him speak, and we are really in really good hands. So it's exciting.
Is he not so interesting to listen to?
He really is. I mean, he is a smart guy, and he's a great speaker. And you know, it's gripping. You know, you really like to hear everything he has to say, and it's just really exciting that we're in the position we're in right now. The guy is a winner. He's won everywhere he's been. He's never had a losing record. And I call it the Rocco effect. We're seeing it. You know, to win a game the way we did the week before, to come back and then finish it off, that's the Rocco effect. And I think we're gonna see more of it moving forward. It's exciting.
Hey, we are excited here in Newark. Great crowd on hand today, and we're actually seeing a good sign. As don't know if we got time to mention this on the air, but earlier in the game, Tenny Adewusi went into the locker room. He had a great day on special teams, and we do see him come out of the locker room and join his teammates on the sideline again. So it looks like Tenny is doing well. So Delaware's offense back on the field. We'll see if they can put together a drive and put this one away. This drive will start at their own 38-yard line, and Delaware already snapped the football, and the timeout is still on the field. So timeout coordinator gives the signal, and we'll hear the whistle to start play again. 4:05 remaining in the fourth quarter from Delaware Stadium, and J.P. Caruso trying to go 2-0. With the Hens as starting quarterback. The give is to Kane, looking for some space. He was riding his blocker, had none to the left side, and got back to line of scrimmage. Armin Jones in on the stop.
Yeah, William & Mary's not giving up. You know they're not going to. Only 3 minutes and 50 seconds left, but they're going to play to the last whistle. There's no doubt about it. Now it's a nice play by them.
Coach Jimmy Laycock, 38th season at the helm of William & Mary. Coached against you in the 90s. Coached against players before you. Coached against players after you.
That's, I mean, an amazing number. 38 years is an amazing number.
He's ahead by far at the longevity table in the CAA, especially after Andy Talley retiring at Villanova. Longtime head coach of the Wildcats. And Wildcats were in some trouble early against James Madison today. We'll get you a scoring update with Benny Pinella after this ball game, as the second down handoff goes to Kenai Kane again, getting some extra yardage up to the 42-yard line. It's going to be third down for Delaware And the clock is stopped. It looks like William & Mary going to call a timeout to stop the clock. That's their first timeout used. 3:12 remaining, and Delaware up 17-0. Delaware, if they can post this shutout, if they can keep William & Mary out of the end zone, a pretty impressive stat. William & Mary has not been shut out since 2011. October 8, 2011, to be exact, when they lost 21-0 against who? The Delaware Blue Hens. That was actually Delaware's last shutout at home back in 2011. So it's been quite some time since the Tribe have stayed off the scoreboard. And
good job. Good fact there.
Michael Bommel helping us out with that stat. And
good job, Mike.
See what the offense can do, though. See if they can continue this drive on third down and six. Delaware just 2 of 15 today on third down. And the single back will be Kenai Kane with J.P. Caruso under center after the William & Mary timeout. A whistle. And it looks like Delaware called a timeout.
Delaware
obviously didn't like something that they saw in that formation or what William & Mary was showing defensively, and they called a timeout. And you can tell Coach Rocco, his staff coaching to the very end, he saw something that he didn't like, and this is an important third down here. This game, while it feels good, certainly not over if William & Mary can get a quick strike, which they've been unable to do.
Never let your guard down.
You got to play to that final whistle, that's
for sure. Never let your guard down. You know, next week is coming very quickly, you know, and the week after that is coming quickly too. So, you know, you always want to be tight and on point with what you're doing, and Coach Rocco is that type of coach. He's very detailed, and he's going to take a timeout no matter when it is if he doesn't like what he sees.
You know, Eddie, while we got a chance here with the timeout for Delaware, we had star power here with you, the All-American. Mike Adams was here. To our right, Quandre Ismail's in the booth.
Yeah, how about that? Isn't that pretty cool?
Yeah, the missile, they called him.
The missile. I remember very well. I wonder what the Rockets up to right now.
And then two booths down for William & Mary. We got Mike Leach, William & Mary, former player in
NFL
player as well. First down, a yardage picked up after the timeout by Kenai Kane, rumbling his way into William & Mary territory, and that's a huge pickup for Delaware, who will likely be able to milk this clock down to a point where the Tribe are going to lose all hope. Clock winding after the first down pickup. It was stopped by Michelle. You're able to talk to Mike Leach. They were kind enough to come and visit us prior to the game, and a lot of good football talent next to dopes like me and Jay for William & Mary.
Well, just so you know, you are far from a dope, my friend. You are very impressive, and I'm glad to be an honor to be up here with you.
We're happy to work with you. J.P. Caruso, first and 10 from the Tribe 45-yard line. In motion goes Chichi Amachi. Haven't seen him today, and the give goes to Thomas Jefferson. 42 is the spot of the ball. Josh Delaney with the tackle. Delaney, a really solid tackler for William & Mary. 29 on the year, 9 tackles for loss, and 3-yard pickup on first down for TJ. They're going to work TJ back slowly. You know, Delaware came into the year thinking it was going to be Wes Hills, Thomas Jefferson, Kareem Williams, and they lose Wes Hills to a suspension. Thomas Jefferson is injured, and it's ended up being Kareem Williams and Kenai Kane. And I think because of the success of Kenai Kane, Jefferson has been able to work himself back in slowly with that rib injury. Second down and 7. Under 2 minutes to play. Hens up 17-0. Caruso, the quarterback, give to the right side. It's Jefferson. And bottled up at the line of scrimmage. Again, that was Josh Delaney. Joe Suarez in there as well. But the important point at this spot of the game is the clock continues to run.
Well, I want to say, you know, now that there's a minute and 38 seconds and we're up 17-0, I have a minute here. I spoke of it just briefly before, but it really is an honor to be up here with you, Scott. You really do an excellent job, and it's a great opportunity, and I've really enjoyed this tonight, so thank you.
Thank you very much, Eddie. We look forward to the rest of the season as well. We got Richmond, Towson, Maine, Albany, Villanova coming up on the schedule, and Delaware hopefully has some more games to play after that as well. They are certainly looking like a team that can end that playoffless streak as Caruso has to get rid of it quickly. Pressure coming from Armin Jones. Incomplete pass. Caruso had no chance there as he went naked bootleg, and Armin Jones was right there to find him. Just had to release it safely.
Yeah. Yep. Get rid of the ball. Don't want to take a big sack. You certainly don't want to fumble. And get out of here unscathed.
Nick Pritchard. He's been the busiest player, I think, on any of these teams today. The punter for Delaware.
Yeah. Really great day. Great, you know, I know Delaware had a great punter before that, so it's good to see that we didn't lose a beat with this kid.
Yeah, good transfer pickup out of the ACC. His first game of his career was actually against Danny Rocco when he was playing for Maryland against Richmond. And now playing for him as Pritchard boots this one. It'll drop at the 5-yard line. Will it stay?
Why not? Why
not? Sure does. How about that? A 1-yard line, the spot of the football. 41-yard punt from the 42. Nick Pritchard has been something exciting.
Player of the game, I got to say.
Been the busiest, that's for sure. Yeah. What a job by Delaware getting down there and Pritchard placing it. I believe it was Tim Sheridan. He's the one on the big screen. Sheridan's the long snapper. And he's the one that got all the way down there and down it. That's impressive,
that
by
impressive.
By Sheridan. And now we'll see some second unit guys getting out there on the field for Delaware with 56 seconds left. Don't go anywhere after the game. We got the American Spirit Federal Credit Union post-game show. We'll hear from head coach Danny Rocco. We'll have highlights back in the studio with Benny Pinella. And Delaware going to improve to 4-2 on the season. Out of the end zone, a shotgun snap. Mitchell still the quarterback. He's going to throw from his end zone. It's caught at the 6-yard line, wrapped up. And clock will turn at 49. Catch was made by the running back, Giles, who came really close to about 7 or 8 blocked punts. He's been working hard and finally gets to play on the offensive side. Picks up 5 on first down. Second down and 6. Mitchell, again, out of the end zone. Pressured, flushed out, on the run. At the 5, throws the football. Pass is caught by Kuzjak. He got his... It's an NFL catch. He got both legs in, both feet down. Only needed one, and that's a nice job by Kuzjak, the team's leading receiver coming into this game, and his 4th catch today, up to 20 on the year.
Well, certainly an important time here for William & Mary, even though there's, you know, less than a minute left, but it's important for them to see, you know, get more, as many reps for this young quarterback as possible and give him the confidence moving forward.
Yeah, play like this is a drive where you can win the ball
game.
You
want to
see Mitchell out there. If he's going to be your guy, this is his first career game.
Next week is coming, yes.
This is important as they'll get ready for James Madison. Certainly doesn't get any easier for William & Mary next week. Mitchell rolling out on 1st and 10, dumps it off to his wide receiver who was standing a few yards ahead of him, but a drop pass at the 24-yard line makes it 2nd and 10. Clock stops at the 17. 17-0. How about Delaware? Going to go 6 straight quarters without allowing a point defensively.
Great.
Incredible.
That is incredible. That's impressive.
This is a defense. They say defense wins championships,
yeah.
And this is the type of defense that can get you wins when your offense is not necessarily clicking.
No doubt about it.
You don't need a whole lot of points when your team on defense is holding opponents under 200 yards. That's where William & Mary stands right now.
Wow.
At 194 total yards of offense. 6 yards will get into 200 on 2nd down and 10. Mitchell going for it all down the field, and Brown in coverage of tosses overthrown to Jack Armstrong. It'll stop the clock with 10 seconds left. Great job by Delaware. Momentum from the Stony Brook game, and they continue that today against the Tribe.
Well, I feel good about one thing, and I was a little bit worried about being up here and being a jinx. So
not at all.
I think I got away with it. With 10
not
seconds left, I can breathe.
That's
now.
Right. You feel a little bit better?
Yeah.
You didn't even need the helmet. You said you would be more comfortable with the helmet.
Yeah, definitely that.
Did a fine job without it.
Yeah.
3rd down and 10 for William & Mary. This should probably be a passing down, so might not be the final play. Mitchell out of shotgun. All day to throw. Going to roll out. Now he's going to tuck. Slides for it at the 27-yard line. And that will be the final play. Delaware has won 2 in a row. They move above 500 in the CAA at 2-1 and prove to 3-1 at Delaware Stadium. A shutout by the defense. 17-0. Hens beat William & Mary. What a game for Delaware. And just outstanding by this defense to force some turnovers, and Delaware's offense, to their credit, they didn't move the football a whole lot in this game, 235 yards total offense, but when they had good field position, minus a 1 interception return by Adewusi, they took advantage, they got field goals or touchdowns on 2 of the 3 turnovers, and that's going to be a key in a game like this.
Yeah, there's nothing wrong with that, you know, it doesn't always have to be pretty. A win is a win. This is a big win coming off of a great performance and great comeback victory last week. You wanted to build on that. You didn't want any kind of letdown. So, you know, I give these guys a lot of credit. The offense struggled today, and that's going to happen, you know. So what happens then? The defense has to step up, and the defense did exactly that. So it wasn't an exciting game, but it's exciting in the sense that it's a win, and now we move forward and build off of what we've done here and look at getting a little bit better for next week.
Yeah, fans of defense thought it was plenty exciting, though.
Yeah.
You know, Eddie Conti, the All-American
right.
wide receiver, used to maybe some more action on the offensive side. But I'll tell you, 17 points, that's all they need. All they needed was 1 point. They shut out William & Mary. I mean, just an outstanding game. Let's go over, Eddie, before we roll into our American Spirit postgame show, some of the keys in this game. And we thought one of the keys would be getting J.P. Caruso off to a fast start. And he didn't necessarily have that. But, again, this was a game where, despite all of that, and a stat line that's not going to look pretty, 7 of 21, 78 yards. Again, it's a game like Stony Brook where he managed it enough that they were able to pull off a victory.
Yeah. So he I would say the manage it is the key word there. He did a good enough job to not cause, you know, any destruction out there. He managed the game. He showed the ability to, when things break down, that he can get out of the pocket and pick up some yardage downfield with his legs. That's good. We don't lose that aspect so much without having Walker back there, you know. He shows that we can still have that ability. And then the excitement of him, getting the ball downfield a little bit is something that we want to see moving forward. Yeah. And guys catching the ball for him, you know, those are the keys, I think. But he didn't do anything to lose this game. He did what he needed to do with his first full start from the beginning. I think we can say that he did a good enough job.
And how about Joe Walker, a captain? Don't forget, a captain on this football team, saying to his squad, whatever you need me to do, coach, whatever you need me to do for this offense, I will do it. And he came out there, ran the football four times for 24 yards, and he was solid out there. It was probably tough for Joe Walker for only the second time in his career not being the starter, and the first time was his very first game as a freshman on this team to come out there and not run the offense, but he did a good job of playing a role for this team, and that's what a captain has to do.
That's a good point, Scott, and that's something that's really important. You know, it had to be tough for him. Let's not say it wasn't. And the way he handled it, it speaks to his character, and that's what we have on this team. We have character guys, you know. Oh, and that's what Coach Rocco looks for. That's what Coach Rocco's all about. And I think that's a great point, and that's a very impressive point for that about Walker.
Game goes 3-0.